Hey fuckers, it's Friday.
I need work.
Good night, folks.
Nailed it.
You are listening to your favorite podcast, Shoutcast Podcast, with your host, Bobby Skullface.
That's a solid unit, Mac.
Oscar and Jake.
I call it a rock friend.
Robert D.
So happy to be here.
The engineer, T2RX6.
It's a fit and finish.
Everyone's favorite internet troll, Greg for Mercy.
Only troll for good.
Meth Deluxe Baldwin.
Hell Hasbro.
And the most popular tattoo transformer fan ever, Decepticon.
Hey, ladies.
No, it's just awful.
Who's running that company?
I don't scale like that.
Upload complete, fuckers.
This podcast is intended for mature audiences only, and its sole purpose is to entertain. If it doesn't fit with your sensitive sensibilities, please feel free to turn it off now and...
Shut the fuck up, Chip.
Good evening, fleshy meat sacks, and welcome to Shattercast Uncut, episode 140. I'm your last-minute host, Decepticon, and joining me from some place called Arkansas, it's birthday boy, Matthew Deluxe Baldwin.
Yay! And we were here first. Fuck you, Kansas.
Arkansas.
I don't believe it's your birthday at the time of the recording, but it's tomorrow, right? So by the time the
show, yes, sir.
All right, happy birthday.
All right, got a happy birthday from a guy from down under.
Yeah,
Boucher.
Yeah, Bobby. He's a good dude.
Bobby. Yeah.
Shout out to Bobby.
Yeah. Other Bobby.
The, you got that? You getting that birthday money for your birthday or what?
from my mom, I am. That's about it. Mm. I got the movie in.
I got you. I was just curious about that.
Got that birthday money.
Got that birthday money.
Right. Can't get that Skullface money in yet.
You ain't get that Skullface money, though. I guess Skullface is more expensive.
It is, man. It's high dollar.
Never mind. I'll talk about it later. I hear you.
All right.
Okay.
Next up, he's seen the light, and we'll find out why and what did you get. It's the one and only Justin T2RX6.
Yeah, there's that. What's going on?
Yeah. How much, man? How you doing?
I am well. Thank you.
All right. Also with us tonight, he keeps the Facebooks running on time. It's the cruel but fair, Greg for Mercy.
Hello.
Hey.
Oh, I thought you dropped off. That was a good intro.
We're coming back with that high energy this week.
Mm.
And speaking of riding high, he's coming in with that latest TFC fish review. It's the all about that weapon mode. Bobby Skullfest.
What's up, everybody? Hey, Skullfest is in just about a week from the day you're hearing this. So if I have reached out to you about coming and just hit me up and try to let me know so I can keep track of my head count. I wish I could invite more people, but my house is only so big. I have more room next year because, you know, Deluxe is off that list, so. We can.
you mean that 3,600 square feet house can accommodate me?
Man, I don't even know what the square footage this thing is, really.
You know, it's about 3,600 at least.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I'm still waiting for my invite in the mail. But
yeah, you got an invite, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I just wanted to have to make you decline.
Yeah, I know.
But yeah, if I did reach out to you, could you please let me know? Because I'm trying to keep. And if you're, let me know if you're coming because I'm trying to buy food and whatnot next week, so I want to be prepared.
Man, hate to run out of burgers.
We're Kool-Aid. Right.
I knew someone was gonna say something about the burgers, man. Don't run out of burgers. Ain't got that burger money.
What did we do for? Because we did that for dinner. Remember what we had for dinner, Greg?
I had one burgers. It was him. Well, I heard there were burgers because I saw people eating them when I got there, and then there was like, chicken.
People in the corner just.
Me and Robert had vodka and cheer wine for dinner. I don't know about you guys.
Shout out to Justin. So yeah, that's all.
All right. And as always, he's bringing it up the rear, or possibly running late, or possibly not making the show at all. It's Robert D. And
Mondoy T-Tox.
So, did anybody get anything? We'll go with you first, Matthew.
Yeah, I picked up another Deadpool because it was out there. So, I may scalp it for about 80. I don't know. Hit me up if you want to pay 80 for it.
I'll give you $80, dudes.
Mm-hmm. Nah, I'm. I don't know. I might just return it. I don't know. Give it somebody else. I got Titan Returns, Weird Wolf, and Mind Wipe. And I'll go check out my Hell Hasbro reviews on it. Pretty good. And fresh off the presses, I got the 30th anniversary movie today, Blu-ray. So I'll be able to watch that soon. And that's it.
Very cool. Very cool. All right. Justin, what did you get?
Let's see. I also got the 30th anniversary movie, which... stupidest digital copy ever. I don't know if anyone tried to redeem it yet, but it takes you to some stupid ass website that's like, hey, download this 5 gig file and keep it on your computer. You know, that's a good digital copy.
Is it the FunPub website?
No, it's
Windows 96.
It's surprisingly not FunPub, but it could be the same company behind it. It's like digital. copydistribution.com or something like that. I don't know. It's really weird. I'm pretty sure that I just like consented to some kind of terrorism or something, but might sign my name to it. I don't know. Yeah. So I got that. Was that great?
I got the Australian version. Well, I was just going to say, I got the Australian version from a couple years ago. And when I clicked to download the digital copy, a scorpion spawned in my living room and I had to fight it.
Nice.
To get mine, so count yourself lucky.
Don't let the blood get on you, man.
Yeah. FunPub Transformers site requests that you enter in your security code on the back of your credit card for a password.
Pretty much.
Oh, hell yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, so I got that. And then I got the production copy of Disorder, finally. So he showed up. And nice. Despotron. And he's pretty awesome. But
nice.
Yay. Yeah, you know, I like him. So I still don't like that little, like, it's neat for transformation, the little piece that flips in on his chest, but I don't like it. I wish that was not there. Other than that, like, I think the transformation's fun, and, like, every gripe that I had about it, like, not standing next to the DX9 one, at least from the front, like, is not there. Like, the thighs don't feel like they're too small and stuff when you don't have another one to compare it to right next to it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, I like it.
Think of that big armpit though.
What?
Sorry, the DX9. I said they don't have that big old
yeah,
armpit.
Yeah. Dude, shout out to John Gibbons. He just hit me up and said he just got his DX9. He's sending this shit back. He said it has melted metal inside the holes, like from the die cast. Like he's returning his. Said it's a total piece of junk. So yeah, shout out to
try and get that shit out quick.
Shout out to that 150.
Got that DX9 money.
He does got that DX9 money.
Getting that shit back in 3 days.
You got that invisible money.
All right. Wait, did you notice any differences between the production version of Disorder and the sample that you got that you have? Have you compared the two?
I did. Outside of the gun being a different color, I haven't really seen anything that's super noticeable. Mm-hmm. I think the fins are a little bit better made on the back. Like, they feel like they're a little more sturdy, I guess.
Right.
But I will say, like, the overall finish of the body feels a little different to me somehow. Like, it I don't know if the material is tweaked just a bit or something, but it feels slightly different. Not enough that... I think it really warrants talking about too much, but yeah, I don't know.
Okay. All right. Very cool. Next up, Greg, what did you get this week?
I got... I don't know if I mentioned it last week. I don't know if I had it yet or not. I can't remember. I don't think I did because of the holiday. But I got the first release Sphinx and Gundog again from Blaine Davis. I couldn't pass up the deal.
Nice.
And I feel like I'm finally back home. I feel like I was reunited with my parents I hadn't seen.
Feels so good,
man. Yeah, it was good. It was good to get out of Fans Toys territory for a while. What else did I get? I got SH Figure Arts Iron Patriot. Saluted for 3 days straight. I got SH Figure Arts Iron Man Mark I don't remember the one from Iron Man, the one from Age of Ultron.
Right.
I got that from Pinkerton. I got a decent deal, so I can pass it up. I'm gonna build a little hull armor at some point when I get my Tony Stark. I got.
That'd be a cool display.
Well, I think they're gonna do one because they're showing one in pictures with at Tony Stark. So I'm thinking something's coming. You'll probably have to get like 15 suits to buy it, but I'm sure there'll be something. I got the Mafex Darth Vader. That's I have no Star Wars in my collection at all. It's okay. I'm not supposed
to. Am I washing the dishes?
Yeah, I am. I'm running hot water over the joints because I was just going to say he's a little stiff at some spots. I'm going to have to hit him with a dryer. But he's pretty decent. Pretty decent. Head don't want to stay on there. Head wants to pop off whenever I move it too much. And
make that head pop off.
Got that head popping off, money.
Pop that down.
With that mouth do, girl.
Pop that down.
And I think that's it. I think that's all I got. I'm sure I'm forgetting something. Oh! I got Rebel Tech Ultron. It's fine.
Light week, huh?
Okay. If you like gummy bears, it's fine.
Is that like a movie Ultron or is it a comic?
Yeah, it's Ultron? No. Mm. I'm gonna give a shit about damn movie Ultron.
Ain't nobody care about that. Fuck your cat.
It was like, did you know Hank Pym made Ultron?
No, it's Tony Stark.
Well, I'm just saying, you know, that's how people care about Ultron.
Yeah.
These millennials. Fucking millennials.
Mm.
Fucking millennials.
All right, Bobby, what did you get?
I got the TFC Overbite. Really like that guy.
No, you didn't. You got Cyberjaw.
That's what I said. Isn't it?
Shark money.
You said Overbite. Isn't that the first one?
Oh, I'm sorry. Cyberjaw.
Yeah.
It's the Overbite was the G1 character.
Mm. Right?
You like that one?
I did. I liked him a lot.
He's got those feet.
The feet feel great.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
Hey. They're fucking terrible.
Yes, they do.
You don't like them?
Can I stop us for 1 second? No. I just want to say congratulations to everybody for not saying feet after we talked about feet. This is a monumental moment for this podcast. It's ruined.
you didn't like the feet, Lenny?
He's got those fake feet with that bit hanging off the back, and then he's got those star screen.
Oh no, not the robot foot, the combined mode.
Oh yeah, okay. The combined mode foot is huge.
It's huge and stable.
Right.
Yes.
Yes, that's fine. I thought you were talking about robot mode feet. Those feet not good.
Oh, yes, those
feet stable for those loose ass knees.
Mm.
Yeah, I mean that's the tankles. Thing. I mean, it's the TFC gamble.
Yeah, that combiner foot is like twice the size of Warbitron Computron's feet. It's fucking huge.
It's huge. Yeah. But it feels stable. Everything feels secure. Everything, it has a good feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I got, what else, if anything? The Marvel Legends Civil War Abomination Wave. I picked that up from Crashbox himself, Mr. Pinkerton. As well as the SH Figuarts First Order Heavy Gunner Trooper. And I also had the opportunity to mess with the Four Horsemen's Mythic Legions figures. They're interesting. And I got to mess with Figma's Guyver figure, which was pretty cool. That would be a tempting one to get if I had like space for little single display pieces. That would be like, I would get that. I would get the Figuarts Bruce Lee. I would get the Leonidas. Like it's a cool little figure.
Get that Freddie Mercury.
yeah. I would get that too. And the Michael Jackson. Are you kidding me?
I want both of them. They've been in my Amazon cart for 6 months.
Absolutely. And I got the Transformers Blu-ray. I got that on Monday. Which I thought was bizarre.
Yeah, some people got theirs on Monday too.
But yeah, I did. And did I get comics? I don't think so. I think that's it.
That's it?
All right. I think so.
I really wish Robert was on by now because I want to ask him what he got. But
What did you get, Lenny?
But he's not. I got sent just a couple of things. I picked up that MMC Felrex card that I was looking for. So a big shout out to David C. And John Gibbons sent me some of the stuff he picked up at TFCon, just the little like place card holders for the Clear Sphinx and stuff. So thank you for that. It's very cool. Other than that, no toys. Got nothing.
Oh, big shout out to Emma Gonzalez for sending me a request on Skype. I will be accepting that, and we'll be talking later. So big shout out to her.
You just got to verify your age with those last three numbers of your credit card.
That is true.
You can talk to her about all those Marvel Legends you're getting next week. Spoilers.
Yay.
Oh, I did forget I got a couple Marvel Legends too, but I didn't want to go before Matt because most of them are his. But I got Silk and White Boy Ultimate Spider-Man.
White Boy.
Man, that figure was creepy. I don't know how I feel about that. I put that Parker head on him, and those hands, I put the wall-crawling hands, and he just looks like he's a fucking horny little teenager out to grab all the boobs again. It's fucking weird.
Oh, yeah. That space in him.
Oh, yeah. Did I tell you I'm sending you the Silk part? I don't know if we discussed that, but I was going to send you my Silk. Okay, all right. So you can have some space in him. If you ever find a Silk at retail, you can just pay me back.
Okay.
So I can scalp that shit.
I haven't seen those around yet, but I don't know. If you need any, I don't know if you or Bobby, I know Bobby has, I'm sure you have the Marvel, the Captain America wave with the skull. Do y'all have those? Yes,
I just said that.
No, the first one with the red skull.
Oh, yeah, that shit's fucking shelf for me. Yeah, okay. They could sell that shit. They could sell that shit at $12.99 on clearance
here. Oh, the one with Sharon Carter and them. Is that that one?
Well, Hastings has them. Hopefully, I can pick them up for like $6. I don't know if anybody wants.
Nice.
I may pick them up. So.
Yeah, my store has X-Men $15. Conspicuously, no Wolverines or Deadpools.
Weird.
Yeah, well, I want to get another Iceman. Did you guys see that Iceman, that dude, dry brush?
Yeah, just a simple white Citadel paint. Yeah, just a simple dry brush white.
Yeah, that shit looks like fucking Frosty the Snowman.
Yeah, it made it look real good.
Yeah, they just put another wave out at Walmart, here at my Walmart, and that's why I picked up that Deadpool, but they had the whole wave out. I was like,
I'm glad that that wave is doing well, so hopefully we'll see more and more X-Men, because they have a lot to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, would be good. Plus, I'm glad they didn't. It was at the Toys R Us thing because, you know, everybody has access to them.
Even though I got fucking that first Toys R Us wave cheap as fuck, courtesy of Greg for Mercy.
Thanks, Greg.
Thanks, Greg.
I didn't get any Toys R Us X-Men though.
Nope, you sure didn't. But you posted a link in the chat.
Yeah, I was. Yeah, I was fighting it back then, and now I want. There's like two of the motherfuckers I want. It's $180.
Yeah, you put a link in the chat. Toys R Us was offering them, and there was another deal going on simultaneously at the same time, which was buy one get one half off.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
So I bought the whole wave, buy one get one, and then like half of the wave a second time for Jaina for a gift, because she was heavy into X-Men at the time. It was funny because when she was going through a room and getting rid of all her shit, I saw that Storm there, which it was hard to recognize her as Storm because it just looked like $100 bill sitting there. And I was like, "Hey, you gonna get rid of this?" She's like, no. And I was like, what? You still like this?
I need a new third party transformer.
She was like, yeah, I'm not getting rid of my X-Men. I was like, oh, I thought you wanted to get rid of everything. You want to keep which one? Just Jean Grey? Like, she was like, no, I want to keep Storm. I was like, God damn it. All right.
That's got Megatron's coming out, man. Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need a Jubilee, man. I kind of want that Magneto. The toy this one is, what is it, Bobby? It's fine.
Yeah.
But,
I'll tell you what.
Yeah,
looky, I just reviewed that Abomination wave for this week, and that Toy Biz Wonder Man and Toy Biz Captain Britain, not fine.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I regret most Toy Biz I get. But, I had that whole wave, and the only one I kept out of it was Scarlet Witch.
Oh, really? My Scarlet Witch it looks like she just got off a horse.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but that's neither here nor there. Movie news.
All right, we're done with the Marvel Legends news. So, Michael Bay sets up a car lot in London.
Oh, they got a new... wasn't there a rumor of a new Transformer?
Yeah, they a new one, or...
It's a new one.
Or Cogman.
Cogman, yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't we cover Cogman last week?
Yeah, you were on the show last week. I was here, Matt.
I don't remember Cogman, but okay. Cogman.
He's so easy to remember, you know? Nothing.
I think the whole time
Transformers like characters that don't exist.
I think the whole time you were in the background telling us how we were going to go see it anyway. So
Is that what I do, Greg? Okay.
Well, thanks. It kind of is, but you know.
Yeah, you'll still go see it.
Mm-hmm. So we've got an unknown Cybertronian. So there is one that there is a new one, I guess. The McLaren. What is it? 57.
I thought it was going to be the tarp on top of what looks like Hound.
Oh, it could be. Could be.
The tarp decons.
It's got that tarp money.
That's some nice vehicles, man.
Yeah, that's some money.
Yeah.
Got that car money.
Maybe they toned down the car budget and
turned it down.
Somebody needs to go pay that weed eater some money.
Yeah, I don't know. Lots of cool cars, I guess. Good on them.
I hope they crash a couple of them. I was really hoping that Ferrari was going to crash when Bumblebee crashed in the last movie. That would have been fun.
Damn, we're going to... Not for nothing. We're going to be going through some questions tonight, aren't we?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
There ain't shit going on.
I'm about to throw rocks at the fucking gardener outside my house. That's what I'm going to do. Motherfucker, shut the fuck up. That grass is fucking already low.
Because in my mind, I'm like, man, 8 o'clock is far too late to be fucking with grass.
I know, man.
It's almost 10 a.m. here. So, motherfucker doing daytime shit in the day.
That's future money.
Dang, doing his job.
Yeah. Oh, wait.
All right.
At least we know the world's going to end tomorrow.
All right. So is that the only Michael Bay news we have this week? Motherfucker. Some cars.
We only got one third party news.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Shit.
All right.
Dry spell.
All right. So third party news. We have Iron Factory Drift and Deadlock.
I like them.
They look all right.
I know some of y'all haven't gotten the Iron Factory, but they're really good figures. I mean, I know they're not your scale, but as far as what they put into them, really good. Really good figures.
Mm. Might get some soon.
Good for you.
If I can find
it. Oh, yeah. I think Robert D's kind of upset with you because he's going to bring some stuff for Skullfest for you to play with.
Oh, yeah?
He's a little Maggie.
Could you bring some 2 liters, Matt, when you... Oh, never mind.
I could. Y'all got 2 liters up there, man?
No, I forgot you're not coming. Forget about it.
Top of the food line, grab a bag of ice. On your way.
You say the food giant? Stop at the food giant. Give me some.
No, the food line. We got a food line across the street.
Something. Right on the highway, Jim.
I don't drink sodas anymore, so it'd just be water. So.
Yeah, I mean, these look good. This drift looks good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks fine.
Swords. I like them swords.
I like them ankle rockers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm.
It's better than some of the figures that are bigger than this, that's for sure.
So. Agreed.
Mm-hmm.
And they turn into shapes.
I would be in on more of this stuff if I didn't collect so much shit. Like, I can't, like, you know,
stop
like...
Stop shit, then.
Nah, I can't, man. They're too fucking good, dude. That Figuar Star Wars line is the best toy line I'm collecting right now.
What about Marvel Legends?
They are not the best toy line I'm collecting right now. Are you asking me to quit that too?
Yeah, to quit. No, not Star Wars. I know you're not gonna quit Star Wars, but
yeah,
you can quit
can't
Marvel Legends.
No, man. Like my Marvel Legends collection is actually pretty impressive now. Like
on point.
You'll see next. Oh no. Justin will see you next
week. Man, I told you I could come see you, man. It's not good enough. I mean, so I've already made other plans. Like, well, my wife might be home and my kids might be home.
Well, you said no. Oh, now you're not coming at all.
You said you weren't gonna be home. You said your kids got so many things to do.
I said you had to let me know what time. That's a fact. I said you gotta let me know what time.
I don't know what time. What time can you have me?
You guys want to?
You said I'll let you know. You said I'll let you know what time. And I said okay, cool, please, because I have my kids got.
I can come Tuesday night. I told you that.
Actually, Tuesday. Wait a minute. Next Tuesday?
Yeah.
I'm working.
Oh, God. Mm-hmm. What about Monday?
Yeah, Monday. Monday, I'm free. Laura's working, but I'm free. Oh, I think I'm. Huh?
We have the Dino Nuggets or no?
Yeah. Monday is usually French toast night, but you can come for some French toast.
Fuck. Okay.
It's breakfast for dinner night. All
right.
Best kind of night.
Oh, we'll talk later.
Yeah. All right. So this is anybody in for this?
Well, I was going to talk about the UR Star Wars line a little bit, but.
Oh, you're welcome too. You're welcome too. That's a great fucking line. Yeah.
It is, man. I want to get in on.
I'm in on this.
Do it. You're in on this, man.
I want that.
Yeah, I think so. No, I think they're pretty cheap. So yeah, I think I'll break in them.
How much do these things go for, Matt?
I don't know if they're selling for a two pack. I think like $69 for
$69. No, that's too expensive for these that size figure.
I know,
unless it's a KFC tape, then it's different.
That's true, but they're really poseable, man. They're really good figures. I have to say, Iron Factory, as far as the Legends class, they got the finger on the pulse for that stuff.
You know what you can get for $69?
Something from Justin?
UART's Star Wars figure and a family meal from KFC. Yeah.
That's true, but I don't collect Star Wars, so yeah.
I'm thinking more that's some Bad Cube Grump money. That's $69.99.
That's true.
That's some Justin Tito RX 6 Shipways money.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Shipways.
All right. I want to hold on to this one piece of third-party news as long as I can.
we got some repro.
I want to get that Return of the Jedi Luke, Bobby, but that motherfucker's like $80 on Amazon.
Yeah, it's a good figure.
I got the Stormtrooper coming.
It's awesome. Oh, man, the regular Stormtrooper?
Yeah.
Well, it's the worst one.
I figure if nothing else, I'll have a Stormtrooper and I'll have Darth Vader and I'll have a Boba Fett.
All right. Boba Fett. Just don't judge the line off that Stormtrooper, because that is like the only fucking bummer that they've put out.
Oh, I just need a Stormtrooper.
It's well made.
Gotta have a Stormtrooper.
The face looks stupid.
I know. I've seen pictures of it.
Fort Max labels.
I am moving on. We got Repro Label news. New third-party company, Repro Labels, with arm gap fillers for Fortress Maximus. Yay. Huh.
I say it does look like a pretty damn good like sticker set for it.
I was going to say, look at the last image. It actually comes with casted plastic parts.
Oh, it does too.
Wow, that's pretty
interesting.
Stepping up the game there.
This they got their own YouTube channel now too. Uh-oh. Check them out.
Justin must have put a fire on their asses or something.
Seems like it. Something's going on.
Okay, he said, "Fuck them fucker things. I want shit done now." And they're like, "Oh shit, Justin, hey, means business."
Do you notice their YouTube video isn't who you think it's going to be either?
Who was it supposed to be?
Is it their own people?
Maybe. I don't know. They were sending stuff to that one guy. I forget his name. No, not Ben.
Oh, that one guy.
What's his name?
I remember that one guy.
Like Steve or something.
Oh, man. There's a lot of production value. They got voice effects. Hey,
the sheets. Oh,
Oh, that's Vangelis. That's right. I forgot. Yeah, that's Vangelis doing that one.
Holy shit. Feet!
Awesome. That's awesome. Okay. Sheesh. Alrighty.
Like Angela's doing his General Grievous impression.
Did anybody watch the Combiner War stuff?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, Starscream. He's got the power.
What happened? I don't understand anything that happened in this episode.
He is everything.
No, it's
everything.
I don't understand, Matt. Nothing happened. But things exploded. It was Michael Bay.
Wingblade, spoilers, Wingblade may be gone.
Gone where? She just fell. She's fine.
To Robot Heaven with the seven primes.
Did you enjoy the way that the music just cut in as she got hit and then it was like,
I like the music though. It was
sad falling slow motion music.
I know what. No, it's what isn't that the what when Starscream his little promo before that? Isn't that the same song?
I don't know.
He's emo or something.
What is up with his voice? Just like, yes, I'm Starscream. And
he screamed like a girl whenever he was.
Oh man, I hate electric shocks
or something. Yeah.
Hey, how are you guys viewing it? Because I haven't. It's not on YouTube, and I thought Facebook. I found the app, and the app didn't work for me. And like they don't have it on
iOS. Somebody posts it all the time.
I've been watching the links that go to YouTube.
I watch it in the app, the Go90 app.
Go90? Okay.
I watch it on YouTube, but that might be some of that dollary dues YouTube money.
Got that Go90 app money.
Yeah, got that free money.
Got that ad-free viewing money.
Got that free 99 money.
I don't really know where they're going with it, but I don't know. It's
got that Loch Ness monster money.
Starscream went.
Yeah. And there were bits of combiners flying around, and
yeah, you always had a strapper up on the side on the left or something floating around, and you had somebody else floating around him, and then Megatron, and then Prime, and then I don't know, it was just.
But Prime.
Does anybody else smell some really shitty Facebook customs coming up soon?
Yeah. the
five Combiner Wars figures per limb on Starscream.
The voice actors will be, or Megatron Prime will be at TFCon.
Yep.
Oh, thank God.
I know. I'm getting something signed. My ass cheek.
Mm.
I know. You'll miss it, Lenny.
You can send me PMs afterwards. It's fine.
Word.
And then you can slide it in my DMs, Matt.
Mm.
Oh. Alright. Well, that's the end of that. So we can do Hasbro rumors this week. So we have rumored Overlord and Sky Shadow leader class figures. I want a third party Sky Shadow. Just
so. So the question is, will this come out? Will this Overlord come out before the MMC one?
No. The packaging is sorted. It's coming soon.
Yeah, jeez Louise, though.
Coming soon, like in November?
That fucking thing better be the shit.
Yeah. Well, you know it will.
I don't see this till early next year, probably.
Whoever posted it up on the Facebook the other day, they posted up the packaging image, and I asked them when it's coming out, and they said it's meant to be November, but they'll probably have it before then. I think it was Planet Steel Express. So.
That'd be cool if they got it before TFCon.
Hey, yeah. Does Hasbro do a panel at SCC at NYCC?
I think so.
I can't remember, but that might be a time for them to show off or tease some of this stuff a little bit.
That's true. Yeah,
because we're hearing a ton of rumors, right?
What's the
next month?
Next month?
Yeah, October.
A ton of rumors.
Yeah, there's been a ton of rumors that I've heard. I can't, like Grotesque and like
Don't
Monster
spoil
Bob.
Anything.
I'm sorry, spoilers.
We're in Hasbro rumors news.
You're right.
Probably going to get to
them. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Through the grapevine?
That's my bad, Greg. I'm just being impatient here.
So, I hope, I hope we see more Titan Masters at NYCC, like a whole table full of motherfuckers. Like just little hats.
Oh, that'd be awesome. I'd have so much fun.
The thing that surprised me, but also doesn't really surprise me, is like the number of people. Like I've seen a couple people are like, well, should I cancel my pre-order on like the MMC one? Like because Hasbro is doing one? I'm like, I don't. If you're the type of person who's just going to drop your pre-order because a Hasbro one might be coming, like, I'm suspecting you are not buying the Overlord for the right collection. You know, like, I mean, like, nothing that Hasbro is putting out is really going to be fitting next to my MP collection, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Shout out to Daniel for asking that question on SCU, too. So.
Yeah, I don't know. Was that where that was?
I don't know. Wow.
Yeah, it's Daniel.
I saw it on
Daniel
Facebook.
Daniel L. He asked if which I told him, you know, I don't see the MMC one selling out. I don't see a lot of third party stuff selling out in the future.
You don't think that one's going to sell out, Matt?
No,
I think that has the most buzz about it for an MMC figure for a long time.
Yeah, but all the MMC has buzz. I don't think it'll sell out. I think you can find it later.
Sold out.
Cheaper price.
Think so. Yeah.
Well,
name another.
Gundam was really, really hard to find for a while. You know, like, I don't know.
Please, Sphinx. It's sold out.
Sun Surge has even been told that they're getting a second release, and that hasn't happened yet either.
This won't sell out. Okay.
Yeah, it's. I would say that this is an expensive piece to sell out, Daniel, but. But I would say this, man. This is going to be an IDW Overlord. This is going to be the best IDW Overlord available. Like, whether or not it's good or bad, it will be the best IDW Overlord available. If you, but if you don't care about IDW, if you're more like, I'd rather have the Master Force or whatever it was, Victory Overlord, the Hasbro one might suit your needs better.
Look at the other one too.
I just posted that in that thread. I just came across it scrolling through my Facebook.
Who's the other one? Has a G1? Is a new company?
Yeah,
we talked about last week.
Yeah, we talked about it last week. There is another.
So they have one coming out too. I mean, it just matters what you know. I mean, what your budget is and what you want. You know, in your collection. You know, Matt, you know.
Right. Well, to me they're all three. They honestly all fill different slots. That's why I laughed at Justin's comment, because like I think that the Hasbro one is going to be like a chug G1 quote unquote Overlord. I think the MMC one is going to be your IDW chug Overlord, and the other one will be a Masterpiece Overlord. So they're all different, even though they're the same, going to be the same size. Well, the Masterpiece one and the IDW one.
Do we want to start our own rumors and take a stab at who Sky Shadow will be repainted from?
Ooh. It's leader. What class is it? Do they
leader,
get
leader, leader class.
I think it's going to be
Jetfire.
Yeah, I think Jetfire also.
No. New mold. I love you, Hasbro.
I hope you're right, Matt. Yeah.
I'm making a heart right now for you, Hasbro.
Mm-hmm. Or I mean, it could be the Overlord mold.
Maybe just half of it.
No, I would guess that the leader class one would just turn into one thing.
The Overlord.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm pretty sure if they're gonna make it, it's gonna be the tank and the jet.
You think so?
They'll take the tank from
I actually do. I think Hasbro, if they're going to make an Overlord, they'll attempt to make one as best as they can.
So it's going to be a retool Skylinks and what else? The Rook?
yeah. Probably.
No, I think they'll use the tank from, what was that? Oh, fuck. The Pretender. With the skull face. The skull, what's his name?
Like
Bludgeon.
Oh, yeah. Or they could use the classics Warpath. They could go that route.
That's small, Lenny.
Yeah, well, it's only got to be half the figure, Matt, so it's fine.
Figure. Oh, I'm actually doing my next review on the classic Warpath. Okay.
There you go.
Segway.
Mm. Safety guy again.
The guy.
All right, cool, thanks. So next up we have rumored Megatron MP version 2.0.
Yes!
Figure.
Yeah, it's funny, man. Like, you know, like this news hit like right before our show hits. And like, I know it's confusing, but like a lot of times we record the show far prior to when it actually releases. So like this came out days after we recorded, but
for reference, it's Tuesday right now while we're recording. Correct. And you're listening to this on Friday.
Well,
except for Lenny. Lenny lives in the
future. Except for me.
Except for Lenny and Bobby.
Yep.
But I all right, so let's talk about this. How do we feel about this? This is big news. I mean, this is a big picture.
You don't want to talk about it, Matt?
No.
I'll talk about it. That's fine. We'll move on.
I heard a rumor. Anybody heard any rumors about it? Let me ask that.
I heard a rumor from Greg, so I think Greg should take it.
Well, okay. I saw somebody was saying that they heard from a guy that knows a guy who has a sister that works at a factory in China.
Step cousin.
That has a step cousin on the production floor.
Jimmy. Yeah, I know Jimmy. Cool.
Jimmy. Yeah. Yeah. He's the guy that said that the DJD was canceled.
Mm-hmm.
this was the knockoff, actually, and that there's going to be a knockoff like a month after the real one comes out, which I find that to be kind of incredulous. But we don't know. Takara hasn't said anything, and they don't usually post. I mean, they obviously wouldn't post some shit to Weibo. So. I don't know.
Right.
It's all speculation. It's going to be funny if it turns out to be a third-party figure, though.
Yeah,
there's going to be a lot of motherfuckers eating some crow.
and I would love nothing more than to serve it up.
Yep.
The rumor that I heard was from someone inside, or, you know, from someone who knows somebody who knows somebody who knows somebody who knows a sister's cousin, uncle's roommate's bowling partner who is inside.
Oh, Jerry Wan? Exactly.
The same. That... these were pictures taken. They've been circulating in the third party world for 6 months. And they were taken during the Takara Tomy error report, which is when they had their first finished prototype, they have it finished. And then they bring these people in and these engineers, I guess, go through it and pick out things that should be fixed, tweaked, whatever, before it starts to be like a real thing. So I don't know. Now, how do we feel about this?
Wait. I got a rumor too from Bob's Tackle and Shop.
Okay, what does Bob say?
Nah, I don't know. That's all I got, man.
You just have the lead up for the joke.
Yeah, damn it. Just a bit outside.
Bobby, it's a prototype. It's been circulating for about 6 months. Yeah,
it's a prototype joke.
Yeah, chance.
Greg, I agree with you. I think it looks really good as well. I think the things that make me think it's Takara are the hands,
the feet, the legs, then the feet,
The thighs, the engineering on the thighs.
What about that barrel?
Got that thigh money.
Thigh high money. And
you need to work out on them thighs, man. Got some chicken thighs.
I think this looks really, really good. My issues are the weird zigzag cracks in the pelvis.
The vagina.
Do you think it's gonna be like brake lines? Like panel lines.
For the joint to move?
Or for them to fold out for transformation.
Absolutely.
That middle piece will fold together and those two parts will come out and like wrap around and it'll like connect with some other biz.
I absolutely think that it's definitely it's not a design, like it's not as much an aesthetic thing as it is a engineering thing, but it still looks strange to me. Mm-hmm. And then the big, like Matt said, the big vagina in the center of it.
Dude, he's that second pick, he's doing that fucking Fat Joe lean back.
But I think the arms look great. I think the fucking legs look great. I think the chest maybe is not. It's not, I think, what people think of when they think of Megatron, but it's not off either. The only thing that I thought one way, and then Greg felt the other way, so whatever. You know, maybe I was off, but looking at this, and it may just be because I was used to looking at the Make Toys one or whatever, but looking at this for the first time, I was like, man, the head looks a little big for my taste, but Greg thought it was more proportioned, and the more I see it, the more it's growing on me, so I don't know.
Yeah, is that head, it looks, yeah. And that facial expression, that looks good.
Yeah. I like the head on it. I think from the neck up, it's fine. But
gotcha.
Okay. Let me ask
this.
They're
going to make this thing a parts former. That's where they're going to get you. You have to break it down into six sections and put it back together like Legos.
Like you're smuggling it through customs?
If this is true and it is Takara, the masterpiece, is anybody selling their MMC-1 or DX9 cereal box? Nope.
I'm not going to sell my MMC one because I don't have one. Nor will I sell my Make Toys.
Oh, Make Toys. Oh, God damn. Yeah, whatever. You know the M&Ms. Whatever.
Thanks for pulling my my little slip there all the time.
Thank you. Thank you, Justin.
Yep. This looks like a fine second Megatron.
The okay. I don't like the feet, though. Like, they look like shells with...
Like Shockwave's feet?
Exactly. It looks worse than Shockwave's to me. I don't know. Maybe just me. But I don't know. I don't care for that one. I don't like his little abdomen area. Like, that doesn't really do anything for me either. I don't know. I'm not sure.
What is it design wise?
Yeah, it's like, I don't know. Maybe once it has color, I'll think different about it. But like, I don't like the way it comes off the chest. He literally has an hourglass figure going on there. You know, like. I don't know. Mm. I really don't like that for some reason.
I'm gonna masturbate to that now.
I do think that the abdomen, like the maybe from the pelvis up, looks a little smushed.
Yeah, it looks like he's wearing his pants a little too high.
Yeah.
These ain't the five colors, are they?
I'm sure it is, man.
Yeah, well, some of them will be because he's gray. But
this could be Sleep Mode Megatron.
Somebody pointed out too that and I'm not looking at the picture right now because I don't want to tempt fate with my Skype crashing, but
Skype.
It looks a little uneven to where, I mean, it's prototype, so maybe it's just not like it's just loose. It's a gray prototype, so maybe it extends a little more.
Oh, the knee.
The waist from the
abdomen.
Hips?
Yeah, the abdomen, like the whole upper area, may extend more.
I see what you think.
Because the chest comes up. And, yeah. Well, then there was that other picture. There was that other picture that was colored, like a digibash. Now, was that an actual posed picture?
No, that was a digital drawing that was then of the toy design. So it's not actually the toy that's been digibashed.
I think somebody had the name on there.
It's someone with took the name some off mad something. Skills, though. So shout out to that.
I couldn't figure out what's going on because the post was too many people arguing over figures that aren't even in people's hands yet. And who was an idiot and whose mom was a whore for buying Make Toys and just gave up trying to figure out.
Do they really say that? That's not nice.
Oh, well, you know how these motherfuckers are.
You know. Do y'all like the hip skirts? Because Ironhide had hip skirts and he has hip skirts. What's the difference?
Oh, here we go.
Oh, well, here we go. Because Ironhide's not supposed to have hip skirts, right?
Right.
All right.
Look at you answering your own question.
Look at me. I'm coming up in life right now.
Good for you.
That old age, man. I like it. I hope it is true that it is Takara, and because this, I am going to get the Make Toys one also. But this would make a great second addition to my collection as another Megatron. I love the size of the cannon. The head, I think, really looks nice. The thighs are kind of little chickeny, but. I like it.
But what I will say about this, I think the Transformer community this week has pointed out to me that my collection, I think, doesn't need to be cartoon accurate anymore. Because this is cartoon accurate, but this is not what I want my Megatron to look like, I've decided. So, and that's fine. I mean, if people love this, that's fine, and you can get it, and that's great. But
Bay wins.
It's I'm seeing it across my collection a lot more these days that I'm probably not going for cartoon accurate anymore.
Didn't like it.
There
why
he is.
The, why don't you ask your gardener?
Yes. What do you think about it?
I'm all out of rocks, motherfucker.
He's going crazy. What do you think about Megatron?
Yeah.
I asked your gardener if he's got that Megatron money.
Yeah. All right, I'll mute again. Hey, Robert.
Hello.
I'm going to go quiet for a little bit.
Did you take time off from doing T-Talks to get on here?
Something like that.
Filming tonight. So,
what's going on?
What do you think of Megatron?
What do you think of this Megatron? I don't know. I mean, I'm all fucked in the head right now, man. I feel like I just visited a North Korean village in a propaganda fucking thing. Like, I'm
glad you came onto the show like that.
I'm coming off this DX9 high, and I'm in a big low right now, so I don't know what to believe. You know, if it looked like that, but it was really well articulated, transformed really cool, and it was made out of good materials, I mean, I'd take that over this thing. That looks great from the front. But it's like this DX9. It's just it's like a ghost town cardboard cutout. You think there's someone standing in front of the saloon, and you walk up to him, and you look sideways, and it's just a fucking cutout of a person.
You know? I thought I passed on that piece of shit.
Jeez. Oh, Robert, can you please send that to me to review?
Yes, yes. I'm sending it to.
He can't send it to you, Bobby. He's already broken it.
it transforms. Yeah, it broke. There's
a part, transformer transformed. Holy shit!
Shut up. There's the gun. Yes, yes, it did. The gun barrel is diecast, and the base of the gun barrel has a hole that plugs into the back of the plastic chest. You know, like, you know, how it swings around, however Megatron does. And in that plastic chest is a plastic plug. So the tolerances on this thing are so obnoxiously tight, not third party, you know, scary tight, ridiculously tight, impossibly tight. And once you've got it pegged in, it's now this metal, this metal piece is inside of a box, and there's only one way to pull it out. You have to hinge it out. It's only one way to move it. And it's the metal hole just sheared off the peg. I mean, I don't know how it's supposed to pop off the peg without snapping it off. I mean, a lot of people talk about having tightness issues. You know, mine just cracked right off just pulling the hinge. And John G, he actually PM'd me. He didn't even know that this happened to mine. He showed me his in the same place, and his diecast hole is full of slag. And I don't mean a Dinobot.
Oh, so did John Gibbons. That.
I said John G.
Oh, I thought you were talking about. He's okay.
Jay Gibbons, man. Shit,
He's let it be known to us that he's okay with his first and last name. Okay. I thought you were talking about Garringer when you said John G.
Oh.
Hey, Robert, you got that break transformer money? Because you always break your shit.
Listen, this isn't the only fault of mine is. None, really. I mean, I don't think this is my fault.
It's not. It's not your fault at all. None.
No.
At all.
Not at all. Nope. There's no shit. Fool me twice, shame on me.
We have firm confirmation that this is a widespread issue. This isn't just Robert yanking on it like he's 13.
I'm the only person. Listen, there's only one way to move this part out. There's no yanking and moving it the wrong way. There's only one way that it moves. The problem is these tolerances are insanely tight. There are other places on this figure that I almost thought I couldn't transform it back into bot mode. It's not going from bot to gun. It's going from gun to bot. When everything's is sealed together, getting it apart is almost impossible. You almost have to damage your plastic to get something between spaces in a few places, but it's this part. It's this one part that I it wasn't like I was ham-fisting it. I mean, you have to be like, you know, when you're fucking moving something, you're pushing so hard that your hands are shaking. It's like that hard. You have to move to get the thing to pop out anyway. And on mine, it snapped it off. Obviously, I mean, there's no clearance. It's just a piece of metal shearing off a plastic peg with no clearance.
Good thing we finally got a masterpiece scale Megatron. We could transform to gun and back without it breaking.
Well, I mean, it still transforms. This just secures the gun barrel in alt mode. You can still have it in alt mode.
It's just you'll be able to swing the gun barrel around if you feel like it. You could shoot around a corner. Hey, he's modified. But
gun cannot be straight.
Yeah, I don't need a sawed off Megatron. I'm good.
Yeah, no, it's still all together. It just doesn't stay secure. You could swing it around.
So, are you sending it back or what?
Well, I don't know how far I should go into the details on that, but the guy I bought it from wanted me to pay shipping back, and then to him, and then
to China.
Yep, to be shipped back to me, and I'm not happy with that at all because I'm not paying $70 extra. I'm not paying triple shipping because I've already paid for shipping. So why the fuck should I pay triple shipping to get a working figure? And he said, "Oh, I'm gonna test it out before I send it to you." I'm like, "Good, don't break it." But I'd like to. I wonder how many figures you go through that'll transform back and forth safely before I get one. But I'm not gonna do it because it bothers me to have a new figure that I know. I know it's broken, but I'm not gonna
claim that, man. If he didn't pay shipping on that shit, man, I'd file a fucking claim, dude. That's ridiculous. Like, I've heard this fucking song and dance many times from you about figures that broke. Like, that's bullshit. You ain't got that round trip cruise to fucking Hong Kong money. Like, if he's not gonna pay the return shipping on a defective product, I mean, assuming that it's a widespread issue, then you should not buy from this person anymore, and you should file a claim.
Not to. That's a good point.
That's just bad business.
Yeah, no, because I'm not
bad business.
Buy in the U.S.
That's knockoff sellers on eBay business practice right there.
Yeah.
Like, so, you want to send it back? Sure. You got to pay $30 shipping on that to get your $15 refund, though. I mean, that's bullshit, man. Yeah. Well,
that's a good idea. I didn't think about filing paper.
When are you getting your Despotron?
That's coming like the 15th. I was getting both the whole time.
Where'd you get that from?
Brandon.
Robert. Oh, good. Yeah. Okay.
Robert.
Got that Brandon money.
Send it. Robert, send it in the chat where you got it from.
Oh, I can fucking.
I'll send it in the chat.
I'll send it in the chat. Hold on. Let's see if I'm right.
Can we finish Hasbro too?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. We're doing a podcast. Next up, we have other rumored Titans Returns figures.
Yeah.
All right, we're getting ready to go spoilers. Getting ready to go heavy spoilers.
All right.
Ready, King.
Yes.
All right, quick switch.
Deathsaurus,
Octane, Tidal Wave. That's cool.
Predaking.
Oh, we're gonna. Okay, yep.
Oh, we're going back. Okay, I was just reading.
Because we didn't do these, right?
Well, quick switch is. I wonder what they'll repaint into quick switch.
Probably gonna be six shot.
No.
I think this is gonna be one of those little Titan masters.
Quit fucking with me.
It's just gonna be a little head. $5 price point.
they already showed their Hexatron. I keep saying Hexatron, the six shot.
Yeah, it looks good though. Recolor to quick switch. Yeah. We got Blitzwing Octane, which we know about. Mm-hmm. Tidal Wave. I wonder what they're gonna do from Tidal Wave.
Aren't they?
They've already shown Tidal Wave, haven't they? Or someone leaked it or something.
Aren't they making a broadside?
So
a broadside. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, so that's probably gonna be what Tidal Wave, just green.
Yep.
Ooh, RC, Perceptor, Cup.
Another RC?
Wow.
Nautica? Are they? That's a shirt. That's a good brand.
Not a what?
Not a cunt? Not a lick of paint. Fastlane, Cloud Raker, Wingspan. Oh, that's cool. Pounce, Cloud Getaway.
Beach Cloud Raker. Cosmos.
Another Legends Cosmos. Motherfuckers.
Doesn't another rumor that he ends the line? That he ends, Cosmos ends a line?
I can't wait for this shit, man.
I know one little boy. I know one special little boy in Virginia who's going to be head over heels for a Headmaster RC.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know he lived in Virginia.
I think he does. I think he lives in Virginia. He might still live in North Carolina. But I remember he lived in Virginia.
He sounds like he lives in the deep south.
Massey?
They got some stuff coming below, too.
Shout out to Massey. Fuck yeah.
What'd you call this? I'll pick up this Nautica. Maybe Tidal Wave. Probably not, because I don't think the broadside mold will look like how I want my Tidal Wave to look.
No. It won't look like you on your broadside to look, probably, either.
I think I'll pick up the Nautica and probably call that a day.
They're going to do it.
Do you think Nautica's going to come with one of those floaty keychain things? Key fobs?
Or a wrench?
Yeah, same. The Robert and Matt got my joke. They know all about that Nautica fucking key fob.
I got some Nautica shirts in the closet trying to fit back into. Mm-hmm.
I haven't worn a Nautica shirt in a really long time. I used to have some
I went straight from Nautica to FUBU.
I had a Nautica.
Oh, FUBU. That's the FUBU jerseys.
I never had a FUBU.
Isn't that a Nautica robe? Don't you have a Nautica robe?
I do have a Nautica robe. Good call. I have a Bufu. I have a Bufu.
That was a knockoff FUBU.
Yeah, buy us. Fuck you. I did have the I had this Nautica leather jacket, man. It was the best leather jacket I ever had in my life. It was leather.
Cause when you're on the high seas,
right. It was like a nice smooth lamb wet leather on the outside, and on the inside it was like fuzzy, like not like wool, but like just like a soft fuzziness. And I left it on top of my dog. I left it on top of my dog crate, and my dog Bam, that's dead, like grabbed part of the sleeve, ripped it into the crate, and just tore it to shreds. Oh, I've never been able to find it since. Like a replacement. Yeah.
There's a bunch of other ones coming out too.
Mm. Wait, do we think Predaking is going to be a combiner?
Or no, it's going to be a headmaster.
It'll be a dragon for sure.
You think so?
Yeah, from R.I.D.
No,
from R.I.D.
I think it'll be a combiner.
Or Cybertron.
I'm not sure. Because like it's labeled as Predaking.
Yeah.
Unless it's a box set.
Well, yeah, there's also Abominus. There's also Abominus labeled as Abominus.
It's going to be a box set.
I would say the same thing. I would say the same thing there, that it's going to be either a box set or...
Well, Hasbro didn't write this rumor article though, so.
They're just gonna paint mine like red.
Predaking will probably be let's go with Skylynx as the main body.
Yeah.
It could be just a recolor of the Cybertron, Cryolux, or whatever it was. Anyway, guess which one I'm.
Never mind. Sorry.
Go great.
The talking over show.
I was just gonna say, okay, well, this wasn't a problem until you got on. Just saying, you're bad luck.
Talking to you, Matt.
I could see Skylynx, like a Skylynx retool, being the main body, and then which is fucking stupid, but whatever. And then having like heavy retooled, like the Rook mold for the legs and.
Alpha Bravo.
Yep. That's beefy. Well, yeah, I mean that's a beefy. That's a bulky mold. You could slap on some animal legs. And yeah, Alpha. Yeah, one of the flyer.
What if they use bodies, the Zunes?
So they'll just call it Cybertronian mode Predaking. That way
I didn't say it was going to be good. I just said I can see how they're going to fuck it up.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Bobby.
Yeah.
If this is true, which one do you think I'm going to get?
All of them.
All right.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, the more I'm looking at this, right, between Predaking, Abominus, like Snapdragon, I'm thinking that they'll probably be single characters.
I want you to keep talking about that leather coat. I haven't finished.
And these are repaints.
They're saying Dinobot, so they're going into Beast Wars again. They're saying Blood, which is a pretender, so that's out there.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
I would be interested if Grotesque. I can't do it though. For what? Why would I fucking do it? It doesn't fit anything.
Just do it.
I do want some. Some monster bots. I do want some monster bots, but
I'll give you some monster bots.
No, you won't. You're not coming anywhere close to me.
I'm coming to see you. I'm coming to see you. Yes, I am. Monday. I'm going to bring some monster bots.
He's visiting Justin.
Yeah, you got the Justin money. Look, I am interested. I want some third party to tackle the three monster bots so bad. Almost bad enough to buy this, but not quite bad.
Hold on. Let me text Keith.
Yeah. Yeah, could you?
While you're at it, tell me I want a Deathsaurus as well.
If a Chinese company...
You got one. Hasbro.
No.
Bobby, if a Chinese company with no regard for, like, American safety toy safety laws did, like, the spark bots, what the fuck would come out of their mouths?
You just got to go get some butane from the store.
Yeah.
I've been saying that shit for like 2 years. I want a third party set of the spark bots and I want to be BTAM lighters.
All right, let's move along. Hasbro, Shadow Glass.
Are you hosting tonight, Matt? Who's hosting?
Before we do move on, does Hasbro have a Scorponok like recently, or is one coming? Have I not noticed? Because they're doing Black Zorak, or rumored Black Zorak, but no Scorponok.
It'd be a recolor of the Energon. It'd be the recolor of the Energon mold, maybe.
Well, they had on that poll, they had I don't even fucking remember anymore. I stopped caring about that shit a long time ago. Scorponok, Triptychon, and somebody else is the next city bot.
Right,
but the next Titan.
But Triptychon won, right?
Yes.
Yeah, but you know. They weren't going to leave that shit to chance. Like, there's plans for something, and they made sure to say the first. So I'm sure they have an idea for a Scorponok. And yeah, the Black Zarek's probably going to be a black head to go on the Scorponok
yeah.
buddy.
All right,
I mean, okay. I'm speculating.
Yep.
Omega Supreme like their... was the third one, right?
That's right, yeah. Omega Supreme.
It's a perfectly good train bot. Omega Supreme from about.
I don't care. Titan Returns is a good line. Fuck y'all.
It's going to be a knockoff oversized Aster Train. Old.
Mm-hmm.
Yo,
man, I saw that yesterday and I couldn't fucking do it. Oh my God. I could not buy it. I wanted to buy it just to check it out, but man, couldn't.
I like them.
All right. We can move on. So Hasbro is going after some of that KO money. So we got Hasbro Asia Shattered Glass MP10.
They don't need no KO money.
Well, the KO had just came out, so that's what made me think of it.
And fuck that shit. Fuck KO.
Yeah, people have been saying that, but they didn't make a fucking Ultra Magnus. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know.
No, I don't know. I didn't see people say that. It's a coincidence, probably. But
yeah, people have been saying it.
This
purple nurple.
I want to know how Bedbugs feels about Takara, or I guess this isn't technically Takara, but a masterpiece fun pub piece.
Me too.
That's what I want a question.
You
want to ask? Yeah, dude, call him right now. Call him right now and put it on speakerphone.
Well, I can. I would have to add him to Skype. I don't have that speakerphone money, Bobby. I don't have the three lines like you do.
Text me his number. I'll call him on speakerphone right now.
My phone doesn't go doot 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 when it rings.
Text me or send it in the chat his number and I'll call him right now on speakerphone.
Let me get it. Hold on. I don't actually have him on speed dial.
This is worth
Bear
it.
With me.
What?
I got him on speed dial.
Oh, God damn it. Hold on. Let me find him.
Got that purple nurple money. Mm-hmm. No? Alrighty.
This would be worth it, but are any of us in on this?
Stop.
Matt is.
No, I haven't got any of those recolors. I didn't get Ultra Magnus. I didn't get. Nah, I'm good.
Well, the Ultra Magnus was a KO. That's why. This isn't a KO, Matt.
No. They did a Ultra Magnus from the MP1.
Yep. Okay, I get that, but not from the MP10.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're right. No, I only MP10. I got the MP10. I got the horse. You're the horse.
That, now that's a nice deco.
It is. Oh, it's gold.
It's
blinging. Mm. It's blinging.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. But the year of the horse one, the only thing I don't like about that one is the gold. Like, I love the black and I love the deeper red on the body.
That thing rolls around town like a Corolla.
Yeah. Like a
gold package.
Mm-hmm. That's some 20s. I got some money for some 20s, but not to make it a Skullfest.
Oh, can you Are you friends with him on Facebook?
Yeah.
Call him on Facebook Messenger.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
You got that? You got that Messenger money?
Yeah, I got that Messenger money. Hold on a second.
Hey, Robert, are you still here? Or did you go? Did you leave? Did you go off? Open your ass.
I'm sorry. I was just co-hosting on Doi Tea Talks really quick. Sorry.
Okay. I just sent that dude so many messages. He probably thinks that fucking. And he's probably gonna see his phone and think there's like a medical family emergency. I even said your house is on fire. I need you to message me back.
PayPal and invoice him, please.
In a way, it is all right, family emergency, right? All right.
Yeah, we are fam.
Pick up.
The hell is that?
He's probably like, who the fuck is calling me on Facebook Messenger?
I don't know. Who does that shit?
Does that?
Whenever I see anybody call me on Facebook Messenger, I just automatically ignore.
Oh, shit. That's why you've been ignoring me?
Oh, no. It's not me. It's not Matt, it's not me that ignores your calls.
That hurt.
And he's never kicked your friend out of the chat.
I talked to Robert all the time on Messenger.
He's not going to answer.
He's probably sitting there. He's like, well, I know a Bobby. But he's probably
thinking to himself, like, this dude must have butt dialed me.
I guess it's possible he's not sitting on Facebook right now.
He is playing tank battles. He's playing tank battles.
No. Oh man, is there a figure as Emperor Palpatine? Because I might need that one too.
Can we finish the last thing and then move
on? I don't think we can move on until Bedbugs comes on, Matt.
Yeah, hold on. I did make contact.
Oh, God.
We don't have anything better to
do. We got questions.
They'll be there next week. It's fine.
We got lots of questions, man.
Bedbugs is actually a very nice, well-spoken, softly spoken young man.
He's a Cowboys fan, though. So.
He's 97 feet tall.
Yes, that's a fact.
I still love when you guys introduce yourself to him at TFCon, and you're like, "Hey, how you doing? I'm Bobby." And he's like, "Hey, how you doing? He's like, "Yeah, I'm Bedbugs." It was the best.
I don't remember that, Robert.
He could tell from your silhouette that you were Bobby Skullfaced. Bobby Skullfaced. I just call you Bobby Skullfaced.
Is he shitfaced?
Yeah. I am fucking Skullfaced right now. Woo!
Are you sitting in your tidy whities and your wife beater shirt? Because and rotten a spike
leaf. That would not be skull faced. If I was skull faced, I would be vaping and drinking coffee.
But he was sitting at the bar and he was talking to guys from Sabertron of all places.
Wow!
And shout out to Mooncake though. That's a cool dude. And Mooncake. Not to say the other ones aren't. I just don't know them. Mooncake.
Bobby hates you.
Mooncake is.
I like moon pies. What the fuck is a moon cake?
You don't like those moon pies anymore, Matt.
That's true.
Well, it's funny because he said like I forget how it came up, but he was like, I was like, do you want me to call you? Like, I think it was like in reference to a video or on a podcast or something. I was like, you want me to call you something else? And he was like, no, just call me moon cake. And I was like, you sure?
Just call me delicious. You're deep.
Oh, shit. Bed bugs just came online on Skype.
I'm 44 pounds down. Yeah, I need 6 more and I'll be 50 before I hit DC, hopefully. Yay.
So am I adding bed bugs to the call or what's going on?
Yeah, add him real quick. All right.
Ooh, we got a guest star.
Hold on. I made contact. Hold on.
Oh, shit. I just got fart.
But then hang up on him like super rudely and abruptly. Like mid-sentence.
We're done.
Bed bugs.
What's up?
What's up, man? We have a question that we wanted to ask you. We wanted to answer live on the show.
Okay.
Kind of.
How do you feel about a Fun Pub product getting a masterpiece release?
I'm torn on it because it does look nice, but at the same time, it's still Fun Pub.
We thought you might feel that way.
Yeah.
All right,
now, hang on.
Thanks for chiming in.
No problem.
Later. Bye, Bedbugs.
Bedbugs don't got that Fun Pub money.
Actually, he does have that Fun Pub money. He got that that half-assed masterpiece one. Hey, I'll give him credit. He actually just he traded a whole bunch of fun pub bullshit from a few years ago for some third party.
Nice.
Got him some generation toys and some he got a whole bunch of shit actually.
Good for him, man.
Yeah, he did a good trade. He traded a bunch of bullshit for some fucking good third party. And an American plate.
Did you guys talk about the issues with apparent issues with Generation Toys Hook?
No.
We usually don't do that until you get on, because we usually don't have problems with our Transformers. But
well, I haven't had the toy yet. It wasn't my subject.
What is the issue?
Well, I defer to my Australian friend.
Yeah, I have it, and I can't see anything wrong with mine, so I don't know what the deal is. But apparently, a couple of the screws are stripping the plastic when you transform the toy, and I didn't transform it into robot mode. I just put it straight into command mode.
Put that shit together.
Mm. But so I don't know. I can't speak on it really because I don't know.
It's enough. I think they're recalling them back.
They are.
Send back out. So.
Yeah.
So good on you, Generation Toy.
The issue is apparently this screw stripping. Like, is that the thing?
The screws are too short, apparently. And I asked the question of why don't they just tell us what size screw to replace them with. But apparently that won't help. So I'm not sure.
I'd actually kind of, not for my sake, but for a lot of people out there, I think it's probably better if they recall them and do it that way, because if you over tighten screws, you start cracking plastic and stuff like that. And there's a lot of inept people who tighten until they can't tighten anymore, and then all of a sudden snap, you know. So
would you call
how
them
how tight is that
Titan Master
Titan
I would not.
Got him.
All right, so Unite Warriors Megatronia box.
Man, I am so into this.
Let's see.
It's just a sample too, okay? So it's not the real.
All right. I'll try not to judge it too hard based off.
Please don't.
Look at him. Look at him shilling it up. He's shilling it up.
Yeah, I take one look at this. I'm like, there's no fucking way they're doing all five Predacons.
What is it? I can't see past
the
sample.
That's the recolor of the Predacons right there.
Is this just...
Come on.
We're just looking at the box artwork, right?
What is it?
Yes, sample.
Yes. It's a giant
It's
robot.
A Victorian. I think it's Victorian recolored.
Mm-hmm. No, because there's cars and shit, too. It's just like the...
They have
or
cars.
They have cars also. I don't know.
Yeah, it is just Victorian recolored.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I was right.
Yeah. You win.
So
you
what?
Win.
Megatron.
You win, but you also
I actually
lose.
Yeah, because I know that.
Megatron.
All right, moving along. Who's in on this one, Robert?
Yes, because I want to have a transvestite Megatron combined.
I just want the box.
This is a sample. On
wow.
The
yeah.
Just sample.
Are you not in
so
on
you
this?
Who?
Oh my
one
God.
At a time.
He's speaking to me. I'm Matthew.
Are you? Are you not in on? Are you not in on this, Matt?
No, I'm not. I did not get Victorian. So
you did not?
Oh, really?
If it goes cheaper, if it goes out like to $30, I'll give it a shot.
Love affair might be
Bobby
over.
Sounded a little heartbroken over there.
I know. I kind of feel like the love affair might be over with you and Hasbro. Is this true, Matt?
No. Combined Wars, yes. I love Titan Returns. It's a good line, and I'm glad I'm going with that one. Combiner Wars, I'm probably done with Combiner Wars.
But Matt, it says Transformers on the box.
It does.
Big red letters.
I thought that.
But I want the sample box.
Easy to read.
So what are y'all saying? I'm a slut. I just want everything. Is that what y'all think?
Have you seen your room?
Yeah. No.
Am I a slut?
Okay. No. I mean, yeah, if this one goes down to $30, yeah, I'll pick it up. But I'm not paying 80 or how much they want, $100, 150 or something? I don't know.
And Lenny just wants that Megatronia box.
He wants the sample box.
It was just a slide up in them DMs.
Yeah. Mm. Give me some of that tight box.
He wants some of that Titan box. Mm.
That reminds me of a trip to the emergency room.
We got like an hour worth of questions.
Hey, Matt.
Yes, sir.
Do you remember my Microsoft password?
Yeah, say it on the show.
No, I do not. Feet?
I was going to play my... I was going to play my Transformers Blu-ray from Straya in the background with the sound off just to have some colors going while we answer questions.
Make sure you're ready to fight off that scorpion.
Yeah.
Microsoft password. I don't know, man. I'm sorry.
I tell you my passwords.
Do you? Oh.
Yes.
That must be another chat. Our secret chat. Secret lovers.
The Robert Lewis chat.
Let's get into these.
Does that thing still exist?
Every day.
I hope so.
Yeah.
In my heart, at least.
Yeah, it's still
there. That's my safe place. That's my safe place.
It's like, Robert ain't here. Fuck that guy. He's talking to his
All right, questions. Here we go.
Questions.
All right.
All right, so the first one was from our good friend, John Gibbons.
John G., what
do you think of the emerging market of the oversized KOs? What started off? Did we do this?
I think we did the last one.
Yes, we did. We did this one. I'll erase that.
Right. I wasn't sure about this one. I deleted the...
We did this one. Last episode mentioned possible. We did this one.
Yes, we don't have 20 questions.
Did we do this? Do you think they'll ever masterpiece?
We have so many questions.
Okay, here we go. This is from Calico Kid, which is a very cool name.
Calico.
What's your least favorite character, not figure, from G1? Example, I like the G1 Skyfire figure, especially the FTMP scaled one coming out, but I have always hated the character to the point that even now I'll skip over episodes with him in it. I actually don't like that.
That's kind of weird.
Least favorite character. I think mine by default would be Wheelie.
I think that's too easy of an answer.
Okay, so we're excluding Wheelie. Excluding Wheelie.
And I want to throw out there, excluding Daniel also.
Yeah.
Okay.
All human characters.
I think I would say probably Sea Spray. But there's a bunch of those, like Sea Spray, Cosmos, Perceptor, like they all kind of bore the shit out of me. There's a lot of the season 2 characters that just didn't really interest me much, personality wise. I can say though, there's not one Decepticon character that doesn't interest me in some way.
Yeah. Oh, I hear you.
Even though I don't really like Starscream.
Oh, fuck yourself.
look, Matt, it's not personal.
It's personal. You made it personal.
It's not personal. I don't like disloyal people, man. And I don't like disloyal characters. I appreciate what his character does to the dynamic of the show. I hate that type of individual that he is.
Like it if all the characters just got
made
along.
Personal. Made it personal.
But yeah, that's me. Who else?
I'll go. Optimus Prime. And
that's just cold blooded. I think. So.
Well, look, it's got nothing to do with me not finding the character interesting. It's more that I'm loyal to the Decepticon cause. So.
Oh, you turned it around on me. Made it so I had to agree with you.
Yep.
I gotcha.
Yeah, but I don't really skip over any episodes.
No, I don't either. Who else?
Know. I don't know.
Fuck
Galvatron.
We lost
the Galvatron.
Fuck Galvatron.
I hate Galvatron. Little piece of shit.
Greg's gone.
No, you don't, Matt.
Yes, I do. Galvatron.
Oh, that's a lie.
No. If you hate Optimus Prime, I hate Galvatron.
I didn't say I hated Starscream.
No. I mean, that's a hard question. I don't really hate a character. I mean, I really like what everyone brings to the table. I mean, that's just me because I love Transformers. Not saying nobody else doesn't love Transformers. I just don't really find even Wheelie. I could put up Wheelie. I mean, he's kind of annoying, but he had his place, you know, and just like the human characters. I just really don't think I hate a character just based on that. So
I've got another one. Skylinks. because he thinks he's so much better.
Oh, I love Skylinks.
With, that's with awesome, all those book smarts and shit.
Well, that's what he was. I mean, that's cool.
Yeah.
True world, man. We all win.
What about you, Justin?
Kind of most of the mini bots. I don't really care for Cosmos. Power Glide always kind of drove me crazy for whatever reason. I don't like him. Sea Spray, also agree. Don't really care for Sea Spray. I don't know. It's just something about the mini bots. Yeah, you know what? He drove me crazy too, because like the way he talked, exactly. Like, it was too much for me. Like, I don't know. Yeah, so that'd be my boat's good to the mini bots.
So you don't like short people?
Exactly.
Fuck midgets. Man. Well, that was me, huh?
What about you, Robert? Did you answer?
No, I think Springer's a turd.
A turd?
What's Springer? A turd?
He's just a fucking turd. He's a green turd. He annoys me. He's boring.
See, to me, a turd means someone that doesn't work. And
he
I feel
puts
like
in work, man.
I feel like he does put in work.
Mm. You don't have time to die.
No, I mean, he just looks like a turd. He's just a turd character.
So you're just going based on looks. You're not.
I don't like him. He's a fucking booger on the screen. I don't like him. He's not interesting. He's a boring guy.
What's Greg
he brings nothing to the table. Brings nothing to the table. I love how Greg keeps hanging up on himself to open their fridge.
No.
This happens. The fridge. It's true.
All right.
We'll come back. Nobody said Hot Rod, though.
Nobody said Hot Rod.
That's funny, man.
It's funny when I go to his fridge.
He keeps hanging up because he keeps opening the fridge, man. Oh, it's free. Oh, that's fucked up, man.
All right. James S. says, I know
that's a new shirt right there. Sorry.
I know there is a lot of playing in Pokemon. Oh, we got to wait for Greg to come back for this one. That's a good question. That could take a long time. Oh, where is Greg? We need him for that one. We'll come back to that one.
I thought I was talking about Pokemon. When you said Pokemon, I'm like, why would we talk about Pokemon?
All right, Triple R. We got a question. I think this might be our first official question from Triple R. Is that a fact?
Oh, his name's Matthew?
It's possible.
Oh, shit.
It's Bum Matthew.
Name four G1 Transformers who deserve to be made as a wave of those little Titan Masters. What
I don't care much for Roar.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, hey, God. Whew.
He's climbed in the fridge.
He closed the fridge and hung up on him.
All right, we're gonna knock this question. Is he gone again?
Yes! He has the ham away.
You guys are making fun of him. He had to get out of the fridge.
Yeah. He opened up the freezer this time.
Oh, God. Okay.
He's not refrigerating the fucking neighborhood, guys.
Four G1 Transformers who deserve to be made as a wave of those little Titan Masters? Are those the little ones that turn into heads?
The heads?
Yeah, the Headmasters.
I think so, yeah.
See, fuck that.
That's not a question.
No, I mean, it's a question, but... Is there anyone that has an answer for this?
A headmaster should be made as a headmaster?
I do.
Right. That's how I think that's how most of us feel. Is there anyone else that doesn't feel that way?
I feel that way.
Are you back? I hope you're back.
Yeah, I figured out what happened.
Jesus.
Apparently, did you guys know that Microsoft on Skype?
Because
I'm 100% sure until I changed my Microsoft password and it kicked me out of Skype. I can figure out why.
Gotcha. So we got a question from R. Greg. That was named four G1 Transformers who deserve to be made as a wave of those little Titan Masters.
Oh, God.
I got it.
Yeah,
some of the pretenders. That'd be pretty cool if some of the pretenders got named to them.
Yeah, I want to see real pretenders.
Mm-hmm. It's probably.
Well, I do too, but I mean, I'm just saying, if they made these little headmasters, I mean, any G1 character, Cosmos would be cool, Warpath.
So was that all the question?
Bumblebee.
Well, yeah, I would imagine that Robert is right. I would imagine that there's some sort of trick bag laid to get hung up in, where like then he's like, but in the independent comic strips that were published in the Bangladesh newspaper, there were so and so, so and so, and so and so who actually turned into headmasters.
See, no, I think he's risen to the point where he'll just be like, you're wrong. It's these four. and that's it.
right. So, like, look, I only want the ones that turn into into headmasters. Like, I don't want any other extra side shit. I feel is unappealing about this. Go ahead.
All those Japanese exclusive headmasters, the ones that all they were heads, and they turned into various beasts. Perfect.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even know about those.
They had Shuffler. He was like a little elephant and turned into a headmaster. They had like a lion thing. He turned into a head.
I bet you that's the answer that he had in his honey trap.
And he knows their names.
Yep. Is there a honey trap?
No, it's called a honey dick. When it's a guy, it's called a honey dick. He was honey.
Okay. I would like to see Starscream, Thundercracker, and Skywarp made into headmasters. Anyways, that's just me.
What's the name of the elephant one, Triple R?
Let's go back to the one question about the Manny.
He's like testing us with a really obscure question.
That's what that is.
He wasn't like, what's your favorite if you could be a character, what would it be?
No, you're wrong.
where do you see Titan Masters in 5 years?
Okay. All right.
Belly.
This question is from James S. This is a good question. I know there is a lot of playing. I believe so. I know there is a lot of playing and might be answered right now. I know there's a lot of playing. I know there's a lot of playing and poking fun at times, but have any of you really been mad at each other?
I'm going to say
that
every
awkward
fucking
silence,
show.
That awkward silence, yes.
I'm going to say every fucking show I'm mad at all y'all. I have to go to my wife and cry. So.
I was mad. I was a little mad at Matt just recently in real life.
For not coming to Skullfest.
I'm not sure if you guys heard. He's not coming to Skullfest.
Mm. Screw you.
Live news update. I just checked my private messages. Bedbug said, I thought for sure when I saw Bobby call me on Facebook that it was a butt dial.
See? That's awesome. So look, I was mad at Matt a couple days ago. Like, we were having a discussion in the chat, and the discussion was getting tense. So my theory is anytime a text format gets tense, you should hop on the phone immediately with that person.
Oh, you should definitely immediately fucking confront them.
Shit gets so misconstrued in text format. So
that's what happened too.
I think he's asking on the show. No, I think his question is when we're on the show, when we're fucking with each other, were any of those occasions real where we were really mad at each other fighting?
Okay.
Pretty much any time I talk to Robert.
When Shattercast broke up, that was real.
That was, and then so we squashed it behind the scenes, and then we're like, let's just play it off as an April Fool's joke.
Mm. Now me and Greg.
See, now I'm mad at you. Why'd you have to out us like that, Bobby? I'm so mad at you.
Now, me and Greg fight all the time. We don't fight on the show, but behind the scenes, we fight a lot. We argue a lot, but I think it's just, and then we just forget about it and go on about our lives. I think that. I don't think they take each other seriously.
I think if anybody gets like
does it's anybody me that get feelings?
Well, let's ask both then. Has anybody been? I think Matt, you've probably been proper mad on the show before. I've gotten that vibe sometimes. Is that true, Matt?
I catch feelings sometimes. Yeah.
Okay. All right. I kind of feel like but that's good. I mean, not that it's good that you catch feelings, but it's good that you
have. Really, you know, but Lisa sometimes says, "Why do you do the show?" Then I'm like, "I don't know, because I love it."
Aw. Wow, he's talking to his wife about leaving us, man. Yeah, shit.
Like, I've never talked about leaving. That's her. She's like, why don't you leave? Because if they make fun of you.
I think you should leave Belisa.
Whoa.
Really?
I'm just kidding.
Oh, can we vote on that?
Yeah.
I don't.
Oh, imagine that talk going there.
Greg,
have you ever been upset with anyone
on the show for real?
I don't think I've been mad for real. I have definitely been annoyed with a few people quite a few times. But, no, not mad like where I wake up the next morning and I'm like, that son of a bitch, I'm driving to fucking Maryland right now.
Oh, man.
Nothing like that.
Had to be Maryland.
Well, Maryland's
not other states on this show.
Maryland's essential. I can reach a lot of things from Maryland.
My trick, Bobby.
What about you, Robert?
I'm always
talking nonsense. How about you answer the question as well?
I'm always mad.
I'm always triggered.
But seriously, on the show, never been mad at anyone. Never know.
Justin.
But me and Roberts have some heated stuff, and even you said
we're just fucking with each other.
Some people
though,
felt a little awkward listening to us, which I would, like I said, I've catch feelings a lot, you know, and because I'm kind of a sensitive guy, but I've never been mad at Robert to where I don't want to talk to him anymore. I don't want to move
fucking
on
with each other.
Yeah,
we're just walking.
So if anybody felt, you know, a little weird, you know, it wasn't, you know. Well, some people said they
like,
you know,
like weird awkward in a sexual way about it. Matt.
Kind of,
like,
it turned you on, you know.
Right.
Like I listen to the show too, and there's sometimes Matt where you've gotten upset about something, and then I've been like, man, this is probably what they're talking about when they say it feels weird. But
I didn't mean it like that, but.
But yeah, I know. I don't think Robert ever means any harm. I mean, even when we fuck with you, I don't think any of us really mean any harm.
No, and you know, we've been together for what, almost 3 years now.
Yeah, 20,000.
You know, we're almost 150 episodes in. You know, I mean, we're all gonna not agree with each other. You know, we're gonna have little skirmishes. But you know, in the end of the day, you know, y'all are a couple of my best friends, you know, and I'll always be there for y'all. And I'm sure that y'all would be the same for me. You know, that's just how it is. You
hey,
know,
man, I need you next Saturday. Okay.
I know.
Justin. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Justin.
He just said that we were only a couple of us.
Right? Yeah. I know. Yeah. That's true.
No, I said all of y'all. You know what I'm saying.
Couple of all y'all.
When I really need you, will you be there next Saturday when I really need you?
I got the ice, man, and the nachos.
What about you, Justin?
I don't recall any times on the show where I've been pissed off at anyone. I think Greg and I have butted heads before, but you know, like for the most part, like I don't think that was on the show. Yeah, I mean, you know, and that's different circumstances, and you know, like I'm like Matt. I consider all you guys like my best of friends. You know, like that's why I do the show all the time. So yeah, I can't think of anything specifically on the show where anybody has butted heads like in a way that has been damaging in any type of way.
Right.
Yeah.
Like all the shit that has had potentially damaging consequences has all been text shit.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
If you want to make it some on the show stuff though, I mean,
it's never been on the show. It's never been in person. It's never been
definitely not in person.
On the phone, it's all text. That's what I've been saying. Like when because I try to say like, look, man, like anytime anybody has it, just get on the fucking phone.
Yeah, if you ever find yourself, there's a good rule to follow. If you ever find yourself like writing to somebody else when you're angry, don't send it. Wait till you hold off. You know, like it's called the Lincoln letter. Like you know, Abraham Lincoln wrote all these nasty letters.
To Lincoln, it's like Tumblr.
You get all these friend fucking requests on Lincoln. Oh, it sucks.
It's like a Ford also.
What about you, Lenny? Have you been mad at anybody?
Oh, yeah, everyone probably. But I'm a Transformer collector and I'm a chef, so I don't like to be told I'm wrong ever. So, but you know, then I remember that it's just toys and I get over that shit.
Sound like a Facebook group.
I don't think I've ever been angry, proper angry at anyone on the show, during the show. I have been angry at everyone off the show, except for not like angry, like I want to fucking hurt somebody. You know, not angry like that. Just like, you know, fucking seriously irritated by another person, like, you know, not to hate them or anything like that, just like you know, like I don't have time for this fucking guy right now. Except for Robert and Lenny. Justin and I had one little spat a long time ago over Ultra Magnus. That
what was this?
he remembers it. He
wouldn't let you ever. I've never had, like, I've had arguments with people where when you're talking to them, you can't get a word in edgewise. This was that, but in text form. And it was like, I couldn't even keep up with the conversation because he was just like, it was like,
yeah, and you know what? My typing teacher back in school told me I'd never make it because I don't type the right way.
It was overwhelming. It was overwhelming. And I forget what aspect of the Ultra Magnus it was over.
I don't remember either anymore. It was an important discussion we were having, though. We remember it so well.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. But, at the end, like, him and I talked, like, because this was in the chat, and him and I talked privately, I think via text, and even then he was like, he was telling me, because I was like, look, man, it was just the amount of text that I was getting, it was like being hammered, like I was a nail. It was like, doot, 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 and I was trying to respond.
Hammering you.
And then, so to speak, and then he was like apologizing for that, but he was doing it the same way. he was like, yeah, I do that sometimes. Ba-doop. People tell me it's gonna be annoying. Ba-doop. So I was like,
he just trolled you, man.
All right, Justin. Next time that you're messaging Bobby, you have to hit send after every word.
Definitely.
I told you about Ultra Mac.
Yeah, that was Justin. I was only, but like, you know, like little things. I got, like, just recently, I was upset with Matt, and then I called him. He screamed my call. Sent me.
Whoa, really?
Smell.
Robert, you knew that. God damn, don't act like it's some new shit.
But then,
he kicked your friend out of the chat.
He called. Yeah, he kicked my buddy out of the chat.
I love that.
He didn't say. I'll tell you that.
Nobody.
Because I forgot he was in there. I often forgot he was in there, and I do still think to this day that you probably should have been like, "Hey, why is that?" You know, and then we should have gone that route with it instead of just like, "Oh, and by the way, yeah, he's gone." Then I wouldn't have been like, "Oh yeah, motherfucker. Well, guess who's back and bring him." You know what I mean? But that's just, you know,
bring him back.
It's hard to fight that urge. But like Robert said, like, you know, make it not because the problem with texting is like you had all this time to sit in front of you and type the perfect thing to try to
unless you're talking to me.
No, like you can piss people off where I feel like it's usually more honest and more, I don't know, authentic when you talk to a person and then you get to see, like, if Matt had picked up his phone, the conversation would have been over in 2 seconds because he said something that he thought it was a joke, and I didn't perceive it as a joke. I take everything as serious unless there's a winky face or an LOL on it.
You like that destroyer guy?
That's my fault. That's my fault.
Guardians?
Yeah, Drax.
Bobby, space.
Now, there were a couple times I took my time, and I typed out some what I thought were well thought out and even balanced messages to Robert, and both times he flipped out on me. Got all
what?
Emotional.
I've never cried. Flipped out at you.
One time you rage quitted the wrong chat. It wasn't even the SEC. You quit another chat.
He's like, fuck. That's hard.
I would never quit the SCU chat.
No, you wouldn't. That's why you rage quit the other one to make your point, but like without damaging anything.
He said next time.
Exactly. Make a hollow point.
Wait, did you rage quit the Robertless chat?
Yes.
Yeah. That's what it was. I also call it Jerusalem, the Holy Land. That's the alternate
name
for it.
That was a good question, James. Thank you.
Yeah
we're going to fight it.
Yeah, mind your business, anything, James.
I don't think anything has lingered too far.
I'm such a fool for you.
I think the same fucking thing. I was trying to make a cranberry joke.
I think that usually it gets dealt with pretty quickly. I know that Matt sometimes gets upset on the show, and you know, I wish he wouldn't, but you know.
Oh, I forget about that shit later on.
I get
worked up at the.
That's
time,
another thing, though, that I want people to understand is like even when Matt gets quiet and he has to get himself together for a bit, like, it never comes up again. It's like, it's not like he's like, hey, guys, last night was really fucked up when you guys were talking about Michael Bay. I really like his work. Like, it's, you know, like, that.
How did you know?
That's not a thing that happens. He's like, have you guys seen you know, The Rock or whatever else he's done.
Armageddon. Bad Boys.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's a good question though, because it is six people, you know, and it's hard to, you know, yeah,
we vote.
And there were, you know, Oscar, you know, when he was in, like, there was, you know, there's always some disagreements, you know, and same with Antoine and so on. Like, so but it was always stuff that was behind the scenes. It was never, it was never public stuff. Because it's just, it's hard.
You know what pissed me off about Antoine?
I like the way you said that.
You know what pissed me off about Antoine? The 5-year question?
Well, Greg, what was the, how did I say what?
Well, you're like, yes, everything. Now, you know, when Oscar was on and Antoine, there was always something. Like, you made it sound like when they were on, there was always something weird.
Oh, no. Just
oh, I know.
Yeah.
I never had a problem with Antoine. I don't think anything. I never really, that I remember. I don't remember really having any.
Yeah, I mean, and most of the time, there's not a problem. And I will agree, there was a while there, man, especially when we first started off. It was like, oh, God, like maybe 6 to 8 months where it just seemed like every time you and Greg interacted.
Oh, yeah,
it would turn into something. And I would text Greg on the side and be like, man, just let him have it.
I don't negotiate with 5-year-olds. Like,
let it go.
Oh, boy. Why not be a 5-year-old?
You text me personally and you're like, fuck you, son of a bitch. You motherfucker think you're fucking funny? And that's how you text me.
You know.
But yeah, like Robert, the thing about Robert doesn't take anything too seriously
at all. Yeah,
which sometimes is a problem on the show, but in real life, it's never an issue.
Line of work, man, I deal with you know, we all have our own heavy shit. My own experience, my day to day life, you know, it's very stressful, and you know, I come here to have fun. You know, and you guys are my friends. So if someone says something fucked up, right, and I take it the wrong way, like knee jerk, I try not to react knee jerk, you know, outwardly, because, you know, I always try to consider, well, where's that person coming from? Maybe they meant something different than the way I took it. And after cooling off, I'm like, yeah, they did. I took it the wrong way. I was being, you know, emotional for no reason.
But
you know,
I mean, like you roll with like somebody could be like, hey, your grandmother was a fucking asshole, and you'd be like, yeah,
she was
her.
A fucking asshole.
Exactly, like that, like that's how you always go with it.
Try to live like that, bro.
You know, and then Lenny is very laid back, so like, you know, it's the same type of thing. Like,
you can't insult Lenny; he just agrees with you.
I don't know. Lenny's gotten kind of mad a couple times.
Oh, yeah, I have.
What?
Like I said, and then I remember it's just toys. So,
I've never gotten an argument with you or anything, have I?
Who?
You.
Yeah, I hate it when you skip ahead. It's fucking my pet peeve with you.
He does it all the time.
All right, we got another question then. Let's go.
All right.
There you go again. Motherfucker.
Carl B. With the aid of third party, a lot of G1 collections are nearing completion along the Masterpiece style line. What position and what business strategies do you guys think Takara has planned for the future? Also, with Titan Returns winding up, what do you think Hasbro's next move is? I think we're already seeing what Takara has planned for the future, and that's dabbling into super popular characters from their other imaginations of Transformers. Like, I think, you know, like kind of like we talked about, was it last week, that you're much more likely to see a Masterpiece Transformers Prime Bulkhead than you are a Masterpiece Fangry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then with so I think that's their kind of plan for that. And who knows after Titan Returns, man? Like, I don't know. It's
Target Masters.
Maybe.
Well,
Walmart exclusive Target Masters.
They did set up that Megatron in the My Little Pony universe, so maybe it'll be a new crossover line.
I mean, they're definitely
the skids yet.
They're definitely trying to do every G1 character over. You know, so like that's the I think the thing is not getting caught up on the name, because like the first one was Combiner Wars and that one was appropriate for the name, but the Titans Returns really doesn't have anything to do with Titans aside from Metroplex. I mean, Fort Max. That's a Freudian slip.
I haven't read the comics far enough to know, but the next big thing happening in the comics is, in all seriousness, the crossover thing with ROM and all that kind of stuff. So maybe the next line will be some kind of crossover line with ROM and
Mask
and
hold on. Oh, that would be so cool.
Spoilers. Light spoilers. Okay, good. I'm muted. Actually, in the comic, Sentinel Prime has an army of Titans. We just don't know what they're going to do with that in the Titan or the toy line.
Okay.
But and Fort Max is being set up to be Fort Max, like Fort Max IDW. I think James Roberts was like, "All right, you fuckers, you get 2 issues of my comic to fuck up, and that's it." And so these last 2 issues of More Than Meets the Eye have been a tie-in. But it didn't involve any of the Lost Light crew at all. It's all like Red Alert, like C-list IDW characters.
No, I'm up to the part where they're setting up the stuff with Fort Max or bringing him back in a lot more.
Hey, Greg? Greg? Are you muted?
Oh, no, it's going to be stuff I buy.
Obviously here. What's up?
Now that you finished Spider-Man, what's the next comic you're reading?
I'm working on Civil War 2. Excuse me. I was muted because I got the burps. I just had a big old drink of
Don't mute those. Don't mute those.
I am actually reading all new, all different Avengers right now, and it's tying in with Uncanny Avengers, so I'm trying to read that too. And I don't know what the fuck's going on. I just missed a lot of shit.
Captain America and Havoc. Havoc is in the Uncanny Avengers, I think.
What?
It's the X-Men. It's Captain America, Falcon. It's Steve Rogers, excuse me. And then Falcon, Captain America, and Rogue.
Yeah, Rogue.
Vision.
Havoc. Scarlet?
No, not Vision. Maybe. Yeah, it's weird. I just read 2 issues of that because it tied in with All New, All Different, which is Miss Marvel, who I really like that character. I really like the way they're doing it. The Kamala.
You're spreading movies out. You're not now just moving ahead with one comic. You're now spreading it out.
Yeah, I'm trying to get a feel for what I like. I'm not just like investing myself in one title. Spider-Man was always my favorite. Like, Spider-Man is like Amazing Spider-Man. Like, that comic ran from 1963 to, 2014?
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was my priority. And now I'm, like, catching up on the other shit.
When you got into Amazing Spider-Man, who was drawing it? Do you know?
McFarlane, I think. Because I got into it in, like, 87?
Yeah, you got into it before me. Because when I got into it, McFarlane had just left to work on proper Spider-Man, and Eric Larson had taken over Amazing Spider-Man.
I got on that Spider-Man train real late. I was the Mark Bagley.
Oh, Mark Bagley. That was after everybody left the Image.
Mm-hmm.
When was this? The away from that.
Yeah. Sorry.
When
was the Sinister Six with Sandman and and Dean McGoffin and all that? That was like 89.
I think by 89, Larson had taken it over. But it was right after McFarlane. I think Larson picked it up.
Still that McFarlane style.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's definitely a Larson. I don't know. If you go on YouTube when you get a chance and watch Eric Larson draw. That dude's a talented man, but like his
the way he holds a pencil is like you would think his hand got stuck in a meat grinder when he was five and he's like just healed. Like his hand, like he holds it like a little mangled thing and he just like whips this thing. It's crazy. I've never seen anything like it.
Yeah.
Don't
watch any of Todd McFarlane's videos though. He's a fucking strange cat.
Dude, he is crazy as a shithouse rat. Let me tell you
What?
Yeah, like rat?
I saw him in New York and he was talking and the crowd, it was like listening to a madman. Like he was laughing at what he was saying, but it wasn't funny and it made it weirder. That dude is just a strange, strange bird. Mm-hmm. But a little comic book kind of like history, like a little Easter egg kind of thing. Michael Jai White, who played Spawn, McFarlane had made some claims that Batman is a goofy character and Spawn is a much more interesting, realistic character.
He is.
And...
Matthew.
Yeah. And Batman. And so anyway, Michael Jai White was Spawn and then he was hired in the Nolanverse to be that criminal that Joker kills. A little bit of tip of the hat.
Message.
Anybody else have any answers? Oh, go ahead.
No.
Peter. I was gonna throw in a comic book guy thing. Did you see that recent video of Rob Liefeld talking about the Deadpool and the Cable figures?
Yes, and a Youngblood reboot, of all things.
Oh, gross.
Yeah, that dude's fucking nut job. No, was it the one where he was freaking out in the interview, and he's like, and so, what is it? We got the car, and we're going to see a movie. Yeah. And then my daughter was like, I don't want to go to the movie. So anyway, we're going to Walgreens. Walgreens is the new thing. We're going to Walgreens. That's so I got my itinerary. It's GPS. I got,
get that brainstorm.
I got 11 Walgreens. Got 11 Walgreens. We go, first one, nothing. Second one, nothing. Zip. Nothing. Zero. Goose egg. Nothing. So I bought them online. $40 for Cable. $90 for Deadpool. And I'm like, damn, got that scalper money.
Yeah.
Can't get Hasbro to send you one, but you got that scalper money.
Yeah, got that brainstorm money. God,
that was the same interview where he talked about a Youngblood reboot, which is weird. But then, like, he said something that made me feel bad for him. I talked about this on Nerd Rage a little bit, but, like, they're like, are you drawing it? He's like, no. He's like, no, that's why it'll be good. And I was like, oh, man. Like,
oh.
Don't say that about yourself. Like, you're fine, buddy. You just weren't as great as everybody thought you were going to be.
You're just fine.
You're the small feet and pockets crowd. Fucking love him.
Yeah, I mean, he was 15 or some shit when he got hired. And it's like everybody thought he was going to be, like, you know, Jesus. Right. And he just didn't really grow much after 18.
Jesus, we got another question.
What would Jesus draw?
He also, if you got time, anybody out there, look up the Rob Liefeld 501 Levi's commercial. It's a great watch. Anybody have any other thoughts to what position or what business strategies Takara has planned for the future?
Style.
I personally don't care because by that point I'll check out and I'll be happy.
Right.
Well, isn't it called Earth Wars? Is it a trilogy? Is this meant to be a trilogy?
Oh, maybe.
So. Justin, are you going to die? That sounded kind of like you're doing something.
It's possible. At some time,
we're all going to die. We're all going to die.
Anybody have anything they want to add to that? Animals. All right. The next one is from Peter M. Or did you have something, Lenny?
No, that's all I had. I think it's meant to be a trilogy. Combiner Wars, Titans Returns, and then whatever comes afterwards.
A movie.
I think I something about that too. Movie. We all have our favorite G1 character. Who is yours, and why does he stand out above everyone else?
I go for a Starscream.
Shit.
Matt, you come pick what Robert said.
Oh, damn it.
We've answered this before, but I think it's been long enough now where we can do it again.
Deadpool.
So let's go around. Matt, Starscream. Why?
He does it for me. No, as a little kid, I remember transforming into a jet, had my wings out, you know, my arms out, flying around and stuff. And he was just one of the characters that stood out for me. You know, what Bobby said, they don't like him because, you know, he's a backstabber. But I think him and Megatron together are a great pair. They work off each other. And I liked him because he transformed into a jet. So, you know.
All right. But I mean, okay.
What? Did I not answer enough good enough for you, Bobby?
Maybe not, because there's a lot of characters that transform into jets, so it's got to be more than that.
Oh, well, I don't know. I mean, I really don't know. I mean, because it actually got me back into Transformers, Armada.
There's something.
Armada got me back into it. Yeah, Scrum. He got me back into actually collecting Transformers. So, and then I did like him as a kid, you know, like I know there's other jets, you know, that transform, but he was, you know, the main one to me. So,
Lenny Galvatron, why?
Galvatron, basically he was the leader of the Decepticons. He was Megatron with all of that power without any restraint, basically. And it drove him crazy. I just like that dynamic, that him being so powerful also drove him so mad.
That's not good enough, man. He was late. There's other leaders too, so you got going. Does that help you, Bobby?
Justin, Jazz, why?
I like the fit. Well, let me rephrase that.
Fit and finish?
Speaking English here.
I like the fit and finish too.
No, I've always loved Porsches, and you know, he is one. So he's got my favorite of the alt modes, especially for the G1 car toys. That's one of my favorites. And like, you know, the fact that he was like second in command to Prime, and he wasn't Bumblebee and all that stuff. Like, there was a lot of reasons that I liked him, just because, you know, of his position in the show. Like, I always felt like, I don't know, I didn't really care for Prowl, even though I love, you know, rescue vehicle decos. Yeah, I don't know. It was just like a combination of those things. Like, he was a more interesting character to me than Prowl was, or most other Autobot cars.
He had more attitude. Kind
of. He had that too.
Greg, I don't know if I know yours offhand. I had a guess. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I know yours offhand.
What's the guess?
Shockwave.
I do like Shockwave, but I don't have any really good reason for liking Shockwave. I liked him because he was purple.
And logical.
Purple, nurple.
And logical.
Who is your favorite, Greg? I think you change every time.
I don't have a favorite. I've never really thought
about it. Okay, that's what it was. Okay.
Yeah, I
knew you had named something, but I knew you would say a couple here and there, but I couldn't remember if you said you had a favorite one.
I don't like that. I don't like that absolute. Only Sith deal in absolutes. I don't behind that shit.
Yeah.
I mean, I can half-ass an answer about. Yeah, no, I really can't. I really can't. Like, I never really had a favorite. I mean, there wasn't one. I had some badass ones. Ultra Magnus looks pretty badass.
Badass.
I'm looking at my shelf, actually, that's all. Looks pretty badass. I like the Junkions because they're fucking chaotic.
Badass.
Blaster's looking pretty badass.
Fuck yeah.
I'm thinking about that. I'm specifically thinking about the scene in Civil War where they're talking about like the cords, and Tony Stark throws open the thing in the kitchen. And he's like, what am I running? Bed and breakfast for a biker gang, and he throws up the picture. He's like, "We killed him. We were flying all around, acting badass." You know what I'm talking about, Bobby? You know?
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah, definitely.
Badass.
Robert, I don't know if I know your favorite either.
Silverbolt.
Mm-hmm.
Silverbolt. That's right. That's right. I did know that. Actually, you know why I know that? Well, actually, the world will know soon. But go ahead.
Oh.
Robert?
No, TikTok is calling me.
Robert, are you muted?
I'm sorry. I was muted because I was vaping.
Okay.
I was going to say Springer. Oh, but in all seriousness. Okay, I'll be serious. Okay. I like Silverbolt because he's very powerful, right? He's the leader and core of the first Autobot combiner, and he's a fucking, you know, what do you call it?
Scared of heights.
He's a supersonic jet, right? But I feel like he's like one of the first characters that was like powerful but also fearful.
A pussy.
You know, I wouldn't say he's a pussy because like bravery is acting not without fear, but acting in the face of fear, you know, and he would have to overcome his fear to do the job that needed to be done.
You know, the more you know.
I always admired him as a character, and I think he's a badass, you know, Transformer. I just can't wait.
The person to name that, to name him as their favorite.
I used your catchphrase. I'm sorry, Greg, but
showing up to the podcast sometime.
I can't. I would have. I can't wait.
How come you're not brave enough to tell your wife no, Robert?
Oh, damn! Them balls out in person.
I'm stupid. I'm definitely stupid. I don't shut my mouth to my wife, and I get into a lot of trouble for it. I can't wait until they come out with a Superior. Like I never bit on TFC because I just don't like it.
Don't do it.
I can't wait until what I see is a proper Superior come out. I'm gonna be so fucking happy.
Anyway. One sec, Matt. C-Dub.
I was going to say, C-Dub was pretty good. I mean, it's not the best. I think there could be better. It's probably one of the better ones.
Well, the C-Dub Silver Bolt is not a bad figure. Like the... I thought
05 was good.
Mine would be... mine is Dead End.
Dead End.
And yeah, it's just because it's a loaded thing. Like, I like... loyalty is a trait. It's a big fan, and he kind of gets a reputation of being like a nihilist, but that's not really true because like a nihilist wouldn't be loyal to the Stunicons. And I like teams. I like teamwork. I like that kind of thing. And that's why I like the Dinobots. That's why I like the Stunicons, because they're like loyal to themselves first, and then to everything else second. Decepticon cause comes second to the Stunicons, after the Stunicons. So that's who I like. I like when they said Starscream's about to kill Megatron. He goes, "Who cares?" And he just doesn't give a shit. Like, it's not Stunicon business. He could really give a fuck. And our next question is from another Jason S. I'm not sure this one has much to discuss, but a general question: what do you think the ratio of sales is for third-party Transformers between the U.S. and Japan?
Greg knows this answer.
I would say, Japan does a lot of the main characters and smaller, because there's not a lot of room over there, so they do a lot of the smaller.
Oh, boy.
I was muted. I said it was between 5 and 20,000%.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, does he mean, like, sales between the United States and they're selling to each other?
No, he means the ratio of sales.
Like, how well do you think third-party products do in Japan versus
compared to? I know, I was just being an asshole. I'm sorry.
The population's bigger over there, so it's probably better.
They're easier to get over there too, aren't they? But they're right there.
It's closer to home. Yeah.
I think that I wish I could ask Joe KW. Actually, you know what? Let me call him.
Why? Because he's Asian?
Call Joe KW.
Racist.
I'll call him right
that
now.
That was fucked up, Bobby.
He went to Japan.
I can call him right now.
This is the call out show.
What?
Yeah, he's a dolphin.
I thought that was a rooster crow.
That was a rooster.
I thought you were calling fucking Rufio.
Joe. You're live on Shattercast.
Yo, Joe.
All right.
Hang up.
Here's the question: when you went to Japan,
do you shave your balls?
How popular were third-party products, and like how many? Like you said, toys were being sold all over the place. How often did you see third-party products?
There's no Toys R Us. There's like Toys the ones everywhere that just sells whatever they sell. One of the biggest places is called Mandrake, and it's like a bunch of them everywhere, and they sell everything. And you would see third-party stuff like right on their shelves.
So it was common to see third-party stuff everywhere?
Yeah.
Did you see anybody purchase one?
Did you see anybody in your travels? Did you see anybody at the counter with one or anything like that? Or did the stock seem particularly low or anything in comparison to the other stuff? Oh, okay. So it was almost
like a comic store.
And then they get you the box. I got you. But it was definitely common.
Yeah, I would see them everywhere. I would see them the add-on kits too. Like I saw CW Devastator with an add-on kit in the storefront.
Very interesting. And would you say you saw any brands more than other brands, or was it kind of even across the board?
No, it's really mismatched. Like I said, it's not like, it doesn't seem like they were trying to carry a bunch of anything. It was just, you know, anything random you would see.
Very interesting. All right, man, thank you for that information. I'm going to let you go, okay?
Oh, that's okay.
Later, dude.
I was going to ask him a question about panties and vending machines, but all right, whatever.
Justin got a question.
Is this going to be a thing? Are we going to call people like that? Is that going to be a thing?
I don't know. I like it, maybe. I kind of like it, too. The
Like, he wants to be a millionaire?
Find a friend.
It's more like Cash Cab.
But I will say that, like...
Mom's like Cash Cab.
With them being... That definitely opens up the possibility of them selling more there. The only thing to contrast that is that everything is being sold, so the competition is much stiffer, so to speak. What were you going to say, Justin?
The one thing I had to run real quick, but I'm back. With respect to the question that we had, the favorite character, one thing that came to mind that I don't know if I know everybody's answer here, but we all have a favorite character, and they have a side, like, who's your favorite character from the opposite faction?
Oh, okay. For me, it's Grimlock. And you know, same type of thing. Mm-hmm. And he's a soldier. Like he's a get it done type of guy. So I dig that too. Anybody, what about you, Lenny? Actually, let's save Lenny for last.
Yeah, I feel like Lenny would be pretty interesting.
Yeah. What about you, Justin?
I think from the other faction, I really like Motormaster. Like the idea of this guy being so powerful, but like his team just hates him, like because of that. Like I kind of dig that. Like I think it's a pretty cool concept. So,
do you think that came across in the cartoon?
You know, it's been so long since I really remember Motormaster's involvement in the cartoon. I think there was though, wasn't there?
Like, I don't know. It's been a long time for me too. But in my head, I don't remember it that way. But you know how that memory is.
Sure.
Yeah, I have to watch those again. What about you, Robert?
Soundwave. I would say Soundwave.
For any reason?
Just I've always fantasized that Soundwave is actually the most powerful Decepticon. And he's just acting from the shadows, you know?
Yeah.
That's all. It's really cool.
What about you, Greg? I know Shockwave is not your favorite, but he's pretty valued character. Do you have an Autobot character that you kind of favor?
Yeah, who's badass?
Hold on.
Bumblebee.
I now that I think about it, I actually am a little more fonder of Autobots than I am Decepticons, but characters, personally, or characters individually, I should say. I like Springer. Springer is pretty good. Wreck-Gar? I like Wreck-Gar, too. Springer and Wreck-Gar are my two favorite characters from Season 3, I would have to say.
And
DefCon. Oh, DefCon. Definitely.
Matt? Of course.
Did Matt go?
Oh, I'm sorry, Matt.
I was going to
say Darth Vader.
Yes, you can. You just did. I know it's kind of weird that Starscream is my favorite Decepticon, but my favorite Autobot is Optimus Prime. I mean, just he's Prime. He's the leader. He's, you know, the heroic, you know, kind of guy. He's totally different from what Starscream is, but heroic. I've always, you know, I think as a kid, I always wanted to be Optimus Prime, you know. And I did get to meet the voice, and that was a good meme, Cody, that you did. Me and Wolverine and me and Peter Cullen meeting. So, I like Prime. I mean, you know. And you could, other than Starscream, I think I have more Primes after that. And so, you know.
Before Lenny goes, does anybody want to take guesses for Lenny's?
Autobot?
I would say Gears.
I'm gonna say Hot Rod because he gets prime whacked.
Okay, that's it.
I say Ham.
You just gave you Fed him the answer.
Yeah, now he's gonna say that.
That's not my answer. That's not my answer.
I say Hound.
I think he's gonna go with Grimlock.
No, he's gonna say Cup because he's gonna say Cup because Cup didn't do more to stop Hot Rod.
And Cup
shitface. He's shitface.
He's gonna say Optimus.
I like Cup too, by the way.
That's killed. He's gonna say Optimus because Optimus is murdered.
Who do you say, Lenny?
All right, I have to go too now. It was going to be Grimlock just because he kind of hates Optimus as much as some of the Decepticons do. At times. But Prowl also, but IDW Prowl, just because he has become such a fucking badass in the comic, and he joined the Constructicons at one stage. And
You know who Prowl kind of is, don't you?
Prowl?
In the comics. He's kind of Batman.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, boy. Here we go. Shout out
to Lenny being the biggest DC fan.
I'm trying to think of Marvel's Batman counterpart.
Shout out to
Nightbird. It's more like Nightbird.
he's like Moon Knight. All right. And then we have a MP collector question, which is appropriate for the release of the 86 movie on Blu-ray this week. So we'll do this one, and then we can roll out.
I'm gonna delete the questions.
All right. Is the 1986 animated movie the true end all and be all? I just got an email from Amazon letting me know that my pre-order for the 30th anniversary edition of the 1986 animated movie just shipped, and it got me thinking about how much we all love this damn movie. The film clocks in at less than 90 minutes, but every single scene has become its own iconic moment for us fans. Taking a look at my Transformers shelf on the old DVD rack, I can see copies of every single episode of the original Sumbo series, each of the Japanese series, as well as Beast Wars. For all those hours and hours of Transformer goodness, however, I think that the 84 minutes of the 1986 movie reign supreme. How about you guys? To put that love to the test, I'd like to have each of the SCU guys answer the following question. If you could only choose one to have access to ever again, would you rather have the ability to watch the 86 animated movie at will or the entire run of the original Sunbo series? Which means more to you guys, MP Collector? Yes. MP Collector, you are still coming to Skullfest, correct? I believe that is the case.
No, fuck you.
No, gotta go to a Red
Skins. He's going to be at TFCon, right?
I don't know. Who wants to go in on this?
Movie all day long.
I will. I'll do it. I'll go first. I'd pick the movie easily. I think the movie. Well, the movie for me is like it redefined Transformers, and they got rid of some of the weaker characters and brought in. Well, not always weaker, but that was a little stab at Matt. They got rid of characters and introduced more interesting characters to me. I guess I don't know. Plus, the animation was better. It had one big cohesive story, and it just has a lot going for it.
Movie all day. Movie all day. The only thing the movie's missing is Inferno.
And
Wheeljack, actually. King Combiners had Devastator. The best combiner.
Emphasis on the S.
Oh, okay.
And occasionally Slag from the Dinobots.
Yeah, every once in a while.
Yeah,
it's not a snarl.
Snarl, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying. I would definitely take the movie. I think, like, for the show, for me anyway, it's like I like probably half of season one, and then like one or two episodes from season two, and then you know a handful of episodes from season three, and that's it. But none of those stand up to, you know, that movie. And like you know, people said, like, you know, the animation was just superb, and for the first time, it made you treat that universe seriously, which I think is a game changer. I think if I had to go to like an abandoned island with just five movies, period,
five copies of Transformers. the animated film.
Or TV shows, like that would be one of my five.
Mm. And that's all on FHE Video. Yeah. Blu-ray shit.
Yeah,
get it out of here.
I want a laser disc.
But yeah, anybody else?
What would your other four movies be, Bobby?
True Romance. Dark Knight. True Romance. Empire Strikes Back. And Goodfellas.
And Star Wars The Phantom Menace.
Matt, what about you?
Well, I just thought of something, though.
What's that?
If your only Star Wars movie was Empire Strikes Back, what if, like, after all those years on that island, you went insane and forgot everything about your past, and you died not knowing how Star Wars ended?
I would just hope that wouldn't happen.
I don't know. I mean, we're being fantastical here. I'm just throwing
up possibilities. And would your imagination be able to come up with all of those fucking Ewoks?
Never in a million years.
And then Luke and Leia go to Build-A-Bear.
What about you, Matt?
I mean, I love the movie, but man, that's 90-something episodes of Transformers.
It's quality over quantity, Matt.
No, not with the Hasbro guy. It's got to be quality.
Yeah. I mean, that's a lot of shows to watch. I don't know. I mean, I love the movie, and like I said, I got it today, and I can't wait to watch it again. And it was a game changer. I mean, you know, one of the first cartoon. I mean, not the first cartoon to cuss, but you know, you had cussing in it. You know, and as a kid, you know, 10 years old, you're like, wow. And all these, you know, people dying, everything. You didn't know why all these robots dying and stuff. I'd probably pick the movie. I mean, I love, you know, G1 as a whole, but I couldn't do without the movie. I mean, it's just, you know, you can watch it every day probably and still not get tired of it. So movie.
Robert, did you chime in?
No, I mean, it's really a difficult question, honestly. You know, because it's not quantity over quality. It's all those characters you wouldn't get to see. All the characters that weren't in the movie. You know, yeah. So that's hard. I don't know. Obviously, the movie's the best. So if I had to pick, I'd say the movie. But I'd really miss being able to watch all those episodes. Really sucked was, you know, when Netflix took all three seasons off. That really blew. You know.
If you get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, I think Discovery, I think has some G.I. Joe. They'll show about two episodes of G.I. Joe and Transformers. Like at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning.
That makes me think about Robert D. Do the Right Thing, Brooklyn Style, in his in his family room with one of those like TV trays, like with a little fold out at the table, with a bowl of cereal, watching the cartoons every morning. While Belisa is like busy like tearing her hair out trying to get the kids together.
That's usually the mornings anyway.
I remember last Skull Fest, which I wasn't there, but I heard about him leaving the family.
That's a classic Skull Fest moment. That's gonna go down in the history books.
He said, "You got it, honey? All right, I'm out."
When he jumped out of the car and ran into Skull Fest and left his wife out there trying to get all the kids out of the car, carrying the baby in the car carrier and the whole bit. Like,
that's right.
He got his ass
still,
when he got
still home. Soaked in sweat, like he fucking did something too.
And that's why he's not allowed on the show until 8 o'clock now.
Shattercast, fuck.
Did you?
It's like it's like that Full Metal Jacket army style punishment. Don't punish the guy, punish the rest of the crew.
Punish the team. Yeah.
So they So guess who's getting beat with a pillowcase full of soap at the next convention or group meetup?
That is actually called a mattress party.
It is,
which I was unaware of, and it was said to me one time, and you can imagine my confusion as to what this person said he was going to do to me. Justin, do you have that? Do you have?
I did not get that when I was in basic training. Just want y'all to know.
Anything else to add?
I'm actually going to be the dissenting person who picks the actual TV show over the movie, and it's not because you know, like, I can admit that the movie is better written, it's better animated, like, there's a lot of things that are better about it, but so much of my own enjoyment of Transformers has come from, like, even the worst of Transformers episodes are memorable in some way to me, you know? And so, like, mermaids. It's 90 minutes of memories versus, like, you know, hours on 20, hours, 000. You know?
See, that's what I said, 90 episodes of Transformers versus one.
Yeah. But, like, let me ask you guys this. We'll go around real quick. Like, if you were to take the movie, assuming that even Justin was, what are the top five episodes you would miss the most, Greg?
Oh, fuck.
Top five I miss the most would be, what are the shittiest fucking ones, goddamn?
Because
if you can't love it at its worst, how are you going to say you love it at its best, right?
What a romantic.
The girl who loves Power Glide. That one where they turned into fish people.
Yes.
Basketball.
Actually, I think the Golden Lagoon is actually a pretty pretty solid episode. The girl who loves Power Glide, the one. Was it Carnage and Sea Miner? Was that the one where they turned into fish?
Yeah. The Hoist going to the movies.
That one. Hoist goes to Hollywood.
How about when they go back in time for the knights? Are they joust?
No, not a Decepticon Raider and King Arthur's Court. I remember that one. I remember that title. What's some season 3 goodness?
Call of Apprentice.
That was a good episode. Mm-hmm. That was some Studio Ox. No, I'm thinking of the bad episodes. Season three was solid. I think about it.
Agreed.
But the one where they pissed off Casey Kasem with the dictator, was it called the dictator? Where they had the
Carbomia?
Remember that one?
Carbomia. Yeah, I'll tell you a good episode that I'll take. This is number 4 for anyone who's counting. Triple Takeover. With
Blitzwing. Oh, yes.
That was a pretty good episode. I mean, it was stupid as fuck.
Which one was it?
That was the one where
Blitzwing and
where Astro Train tries to take over the
football field,
and Blitzwing takes over the football field and thinks the college coach is a military strategist.
He shoots the scoreboard to change the.
I got one more right. Fuck. What's No, fuck.
That about Holland.
What's that one?
The one where Brian plays basketball.
What's that one? Because we said G1, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What's that one from Victory where Star Saber takes his kid to school?
I have no clue.
And he doesn't show up as the little robot Star Saber. He doesn't show up as the combined slightly larger robot Star Saber. He shows up the full-on battle Fortress Star Saber. This is my kid, and I bring him to school
days.
School days.
The So Matt, what would be your five episodes?
I can think of five names. Call of Primitives would definitely be one of them. That's one of my favorite episodes. Starscream's Ghost. Even though Starscream gets killed in that one. Or he's dead in that one. I like that one. That's where they go get a Triptychon and all that shit stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Dinobot Island. That'd probably round off my... There's 3 of them in there. That'd probably round my 5 off right there. Right. I think that's a good one, too.
What about you, Robert?
1, 2, and 3, which is kind of a... Let's call that 1. Right?
Okay.
I like SOS Dinobots.
Well, that's a good one.
Fire in the Sky.
Ooh.
I would say Dinobot Island. Enter the Nightbird.
Yep. That's a good one.
And Attack of the Autobots.
All right. Lenny?
Five Faces of Darkness, parts 1 through 5.
Oh, that's stupid.
Nice. All right, we'll count that as one.
We'll count that as one.
Call of the Primitives is probably my favorite episode. Starscream's Ghost. I really like that episode. SOS Dinobots, probably. Because that was fucking cool when they came into it.
What about the last one? What was the last episode? The last two?
The Headmaster shit?
No. The Prom comes back.
Rebirth?
The final. Yeah, is it? No. Is
the
it
Return of Optimus Prime.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The Return of Optimus Prime. That's a good one, too. Those two.
What else? I think I've still got to pick one more. I mean, Cosmic Rust was okay, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
And who do we have? Justin?
No, Bobby's favorite.
Hold on, Justin?
Yeah, so if we're going to go with 1, 2, and 3 as a single episode, which it really kind of has to be, I picked that. I always really, really loved the Dark Awakening? Is that what it's called? I think it's called Dark Awakening. The one where Optimus Prime's kind of like that zombie thing.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Can
you guys hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I was stuck in, like, call limbo, like the negative zone or something earlier between the two calls, and I was yelling and screaming for help, and no one could hear me, so.
No one can hear you in the negative zone.
That was like Soundwave. Anyway.
Go on, Justin.
Yeah. Prime reference.
Which one was the one with the hate plague? Was that the Return of Optimus Prime? Because I remember.
Yeah, the last one.
Yes, that was Return of Optimus
Prime. Yeah, so that one I think would be good, and I don't even know. Where am I up to right now?
6, 2, 5 or 20,000.
Yeah, that's good enough. That's like 5 or 20,000, so.
Bobby, can I say your favorite episode?
Yeah, go ahead.
Code of Hero.
So mine would be.
Got him!
The first three, Five Faces, Starscream's Brigade, Key to Vector Sigma, and Call of the Primitives.
Oh, I forgot one. One that Starscream with he got Bruticus.
Starscream's
Brigade. Yeah.
Yeah. The only one that I might swap out the original three for Heavy Metal War. That's one of my favorites.
Nice. I thought you would pick the Stunticons, like when they.
I did. I said Key to Vector Sigma.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
So,
are we not redoing mine? We did redo everybody else's.
No. We got yours.
Oh, I was gonna do serious ones this time. But okay.
Go ahead.
My fifth stupidest one was the face of the Ninjika or whatever. God, that episode pissed me off as a kid, and it always came on. Like they'd show the first of a two-parter, and like Megatron's about to conquer the world, and then like the next day it'd be the face of the Ninjika, and I'm like, what the fuck is this?
Nobody said Kremzig. I thought somebody said Kremzig.
What's the one where? What's the second back in time one where they meet? They meet Orion Pax.
Yeah, that's a good one. Where the aerial bots go back in time.
Solid. Yeah, that's a solid.
What about the ones with the green alien ones?
The tentacle faced things.
Yeah, they were like little. They were smaller than them.
Mm. Yeah,
remember they got put into a ball pit or something. Oh, anyways.
Oh yeah, that's not a good one.
I like what's the one with the sandstorm? The one with actually both Octane? The sandstorms were good. Yeah, the one with Octane and the one on the Paradron or whatever. Those were both pretty good. Season 3, man, that was a solid season.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And people dog it, but man, season 3 was Bayformers for fucking people that were born in the 70s.
I think the stories were tighter on season 3.
Yeah, it was like Star Trek. It was less like Sunday morning serial or Saturday morning serial cartoon and more like Star Trek scope of like taking it on a global scale. But anyway, that's just me.
Lenny, do you want to take us out of here?
I can do that. So shout-outs to the Cool Table Network, the ROC, Toy Detox, Plastic Fanatics, Beer and Bolters, and Nerd Rage Radio. Also shout-outs to Third Party Unlimited, at Real Robot, at Fear Corps. I am Ratchet, third party TF Crashes, and Open Your Toys podcast. So this podcast is intended for mature audiences only, and its sole purpose is to entertain. If it doesn't fit with your sensitive sensibilities, feel free to turn it off now and...
Shut the fuck up, Chip.